construction of the key bridge that collapsed yesterday, but he's not willing to give an estimate at this point. The Coast Guard's Deputy Commandant for Operations, Vice Admiral Peter Gauthier, says an underwater survey of the cargo ship that hit the bridge should be finished today.
The vessel is stable, but it still has over 1.5 million gallons of fuel oil and lube oil on board. And it does have 4,700 cargo containers on board.
He says 56 of those contain hazardous materials. The search continues for six construction workers presumed dead.
We've been watching for hours the divers going in and out of the frigid water. The challenge of these elements out here is they try and recover, first and foremost, the bodies of the six workers believed to be at the bottom of this river. And, of course, the Army Corps of Engineer boats are out here, along with the Coast Guard.
Fox's Griff Jenkins on the Patapsco River. Florida has a new law making it a crime to occupy a home without permission, aiming to reduce the cost and time that's needed to evict squatters, which has become a growing problem around the country.
What passes muster in New York and California is not passing muster here. You are not going to be able to commandeer somebody's private property and expect to get away with it.
Governor Ron DeSantis signing a bill that gives police power to remove someone who can't show they have a lease from the property owner. It's also aimed at making it easier for wrongfully evicted tenants to regain access. A California man sentenced to 11 months in prison for making threats against public officials, including then House Speaker Nancy Pelosi and the Homeland Security Secretary. David Carrier pleaded guilty to two counts. Prosecutors say he threatened assaults in voicemail messages. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIPC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
It could cause some problems. Cloudy at 40 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. You got a clear radar, low of 30 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 302. Purdue business professor Amy David predicts supply chain shortages as Baltimore's ports closes. She says car imports from Europe and the Middle East will be delayed. However,
it may actually be an opportunity for some of the car makers that are in the Midwest or locally to gain a little bit of market share.
David says with fewer European cars available, Indiana-based car dealership could attract customers who are looking to buy American. Police say two people are accused of making and using counterfeit cash all throughout the Circle City. Kurt Darling reports.
Detectives say Tommy Lee Jackson Jr. and Kenneth Johnson had an operation where they made fake $100 bills, and they were copies of an older design from the 90s, since newer bills are much harder to replicate. Johnson was arrested this week, says IMPD Lieutenant Shane Foley.
They were able to locate one individual who jumped out of the second floor of the motel and had counterfeit bills on his person.
Talking to Wish TV, Jackson is still on the loose, though. Foley says they used the bills to buy lots of expensive items, even as far out as Fortville. Kirk Darling, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
Three people accused of stealing nearly 600 cans of baby formula from a Walmart in Boonville were arrested. Edgar Ramirez, Nora Zarate, and a juvenile were put in handcuffs last Thursday after Boonville police found the formula inside the car they were driving. Altogether, the cans were worth more than $22,000. You might have heard Indiana's Lieutenant Governor Suzanne Crouch say she wants to eliminate the state's income tax. In a debate on Fox 59 last night, one of her opponents, Eric Doden, said that's a bad idea.
I think it's inappropriate for a governor to make a promise that they can't keep. Our income taxes cannot be axed. It'd be a 40% blow to the budget, $8 billion.
But Crouch said she drastically reduced the tax over time. Both Crouch, Doden, and Indiana Republican Senator Mike Braun, as well as Brad Chambers, all said something has to be done about skyrocketing property taxes. The final GOP debate is going to be April 23rd at IUPUI. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 3:04.
Have you saved enough? Do you have a plan for Social Security and taxes in retirement? Hey, Casey Weed of Howard Bailey Financial, where our mission is to help you gain clarity and purpose and elevate meaning in your life through personal and practical financial strategies. Financial peace of mind means knowing you've covered all of your bases, and for retirement, that begins with building a solid foundation. That's why we want to give you our Retire with Purpose Toolkit at no cost. In it, you'll find valuable information on minimizing taxes, maximizing Social Security, and building a retirement income you can't outlive. Plus, you'll receive a copy of my book, Job Optional. To get your complimentary toolkit, call or text the keyword INFO 42 to 866-482-9559. That's info 42 to 866-482-9559.
Investment advisory services may be offered through Howard Bailey Securities, LLC, a registered investment advisor. Working with Howard Bailey Securities, LLC cannot guarantee investment success or that specific financial goals will be achieved.
The traffic on the fives at 3:05. Here's Matt Baer.
Crash going from downtown out to the airport. It's westbound 70 West Street, blocking the left lane, causing slow traffic back to Meridian, Illinois. And northbound 37 also stopped right now from Epler Avenue to 465 because of construction. Traffic sponsored by Freegee and Freegee Auctioneers. Join Freegee Auctioneers for the Spring Midwest Construction and Farm Public Auction on Thursday, April 4th in Clayton. Bid live on site or online at buyfreegee.com. License AC 312-00002. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Clouds begin to decrease later on today, so some sunshine, but it still stays cool. Highs near 48. Clear skies tonight. Areas of frost developing with lows near 32. I'm Wish TV Storm Tracking Meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Can you believe these characters are weirdos?
So let's rock it!
Nigel, Jason Hammer right over there. You did me a big favor last night, my man. I appreciated it. You watched the Indiana GOP governor's debate, so I wouldn't have to. It was my 10-year-old's birthday. We had family over, and I was really not interested. I will watch it tonight because you're gone tomorrow, and I will let our listeners know anything they missed for tonight's debate. I believe it's on Wish, right? Our news gathering partners.
Back-to-back debate nights. Like in the NBA, you always hear someone is coming off of a back-to-back. Yeah. Well, the debate candidates are coming off of a back-to-back tonight. Wish TV has it. And friend of the show, Phil Sanchez, he's a part of the moderating crew tonight.
Okay.
But let's get into last night. You had Mike Braun, Brad Chambers, Suzanne Crouch, Eric Doden. Those were the ones on the stage. Those who were not on the stage were Jamie Ridenour and Curtis Hill. Now, tonight, Curtis Hill will be on the stage for the Wish TV debate. But Jamie Ridenour, best she could do is debating Rob Kendall earlier in the day.
I know. Again, it's this polling kind of threshold that they have, correct?
Correct.
Yeah.
So, my thoughts on the debate last night, and we're going to play some sound clips in case you missed it, and judging by the interest in ratings, you probably did. We'll play some audio here in just a moment, but my takeaway is this. I'm somebody that, when I haven't been on air, right, I was a marketing director and events director. That was kind of my thing. Did that at the casino. I did that here at the old ownership, at the Emmis building, prior to getting handed the keys to the afternoon show. The way that was set up last night bothered me. The structure of the debate. Because they were trying to get so much in an hour.
There was no commercials.
Right. And it was rapid fire, which, okay, that's great, short attention span theater, but let's be honest, some issues warrant more of a discussion, more of a debate than others. Like last night, the topic of should we all be on the same time zone got the same amount of time as dealing with the taxes in Indiana, the property and the gas. Now, with all due respect to my time zone people, I think one of these is a little bit more important than others.
I mean, time zone is of interest to some, but probably, yeah, the property tax issue, taxes, gas tax, is maybe something you want to concentrate on just a tad more.
Right.
Maybe
right.
Give it a 30 extra seconds. I don't know.
And it wasn't until 27 minutes in until that topic was brought up. And Nigel, you know as well as I do, you've seen focus groups, you've seen numbers. People who watch these debates, they're not hanging on every word. They're probably, unless you're a diehard political animal, and some of you are, you're not watching that entire thing. You probably saw the first couple of minutes and thought, well, this sucks. Let's see if Impractical Jokers or something is on. And that's kind of where I felt last night. And I'm into this kind of stuff. So the debate opened up last night, and the question was, what grade would you give current governor Eric Holcomb for his time in office?
We'd like to now ask each of you for a letter grade to rate Governor Eric Holcomb's time in office.
So you'll each have time to explain, but we'd like that grade first, one by one. Mr. Braun, your grade for Governor Holcomb.
I'll give that a B minus.
Ms. Crouch, your grade.
Some things an A, some things a C.
A or C, Mr. Chambers.
Yeah, I'll give him Governor Holcomb an A.
Mr. Doden.
Oh, I focus on the future. I do not grade past leaders.
Oh, such a weenie response right there. I don't grade past leaders.
I heard Doden on Rob and Casey's show the other day. I didn't really know much about him. Seemed like a likable enough guy. But yeah, the A from Chambers?
An A. Like, so if you were a business owner that was told you're a petri dish and kick rocks because you want to open up and make a living, that guy just said that was fine. That's two thumbs up, an A grade.
You may have lost a few votes for that.
The answer I was most intrigued with was Suzanne Crouch's, because she's the lieutenant governor, right? So she was the wingman or wingwoman, so to speak, to the governor of the United States, of the state of Indiana. So this was her breaking down why she gave an A and a C to Eric Holcomb.
With the economy, we're number one in the Midwest. We're sixth in the nation for our business environment. That would be an A. On COVID, looking back, that would be a C. And as governor, we will not have lockdowns, masks, or mandates when I'm governor because of what it has done to Hoosiers with the increase in anxiety and depression, particularly among our young people. And those young Hoosiers are the future of Indiana.
Yeah, that's the grade would be F, in my opinion, in terms of COVID.
COVID was an F.
Yeah.
Right. Want to tell me he did things well from an economic standpoint.
Sure.
All right. Let's have that conversation. But there's a lot of business owners around here that did everything right. They listened to the advice. They followed the experts. They weren't marching up and down the street throwing bricks through windows. And they were called a petri dish by this current governor. That's a shame. Another point that was brought up last night was illegal immigration in Indiana. Now, again, this is a important topic, but this was brought up before property taxes. This was brought up before the gas tax. The question was, would you use Indiana resources to deport criminal illegals in the state of Indiana, those not seeking asylum? Really, Mike Braun was the only one that kind of showed any backbone answering this question.
Anyone that barged into this country and got released into its interior without a credible fear, that's the criterion. Biden allowed that. Anyone that came in that way will have to leave. And you've seen what governors have done in Florida and in Texas, and you judge for the Hoosiers to see who would actually take that kind of action. I would do that. I wouldn't count on that here otherwise.
And everybody else kind of danced around it, you know, they give long-winded answers until the bell dings.
I don't understand what's wrong with deporting somebody that's here illegally that's committed an actual crime within the state of Indiana. It's one thing to be here illegally and not seeking asylum. I understand that. I get that. But if you've committed, like, drunk driving or something like that, Hammer, it's, you know what I mean? Like,
right.
I don't understand how that's a problem. And it's apparently a problem down in Texas as well.
The other thing that I didn't like last night was we didn't get to hear from all the candidates on certain questions. Because you know me, I'm a death penalty guy. I am romantic when it comes to the death penalty.
Sure.
I like it when bad guys die.
You want to start a death penalty pay-per-view channel?
I do. And maybe one day when I run for governor, we'll have that. But really, only Doden was asked about the death penalty yesterday, and it was specifically about those dealing fentanyl.
So in 15 seconds, to clarify there, would that involve potentially the death penalty? If you were elected governor, would you push for that?
Well, I said I'm pretty clear to the full extent of the law, whatever that law allows.
Okay. So that's a yes, I guess. I don't know. Everybody was a little wishy-washy last night, but specifically on that question, which only Doden got to answer, it was kind of a half-assed, whatever the extent of the law is. I hope Wish TV tonight, I want all the candidates up there. What about some of these scumbags that are on death row in Indiana that are completely out of appeals?
Sure.
And there's a couple of them. There's a couple of them that are totally out of appeals. A cop killer, the Shoney's murderer, they're all there. Curious to find out what these folks think. And then after 27 minutes, taxes were brought up. The question, would you decrease the gas tax? Here's Mike Braun.
So when it comes to the gas tax, the income tax, property tax is really what I hear the most about. We dealt with that when I was in the state legislature. And when a gas tax or a diesel tax would be used for roads and bridges, it wasn't before. We're the crossroads of America, and it costs to keep it like that. If we lose that comparative advantage, you're going to be in trouble. So community crossings, which generates cost sharing between state and communities across the state, local and county governments, they complained about it at first. Now they love it. If we want to keep what we're known best for, if we want to get economic development into this state, you got to make sure your infrastructure is in good shape. When it comes to that, and that happened years ago in the state legislature, that's why we've got roads and bridges in good shape. And almost 48 out of 50 stakeholders said they were for it when that occurred. I'll listen again.
So to follow up here, you're referencing your vote in 2017 in the state house. You voted to support that 10 cent a gallon increase signed into law by the governor. Would you vote the same way on that today? 30 seconds.
I would. I don't think we need a tax increase on gas.
It goes up every year.
In general, the thing we probably ought to be looking at is how do we keep property taxes from getting out of control? And there are other ways.
Okay, you can stop that, Allison. It goes up every year.
Like, what do they think he was going to say about the gas tax? Yeah, we should abolish the gas tax. That's all. He voted for it.
Right.
And, right, like you said, in perpetuity, it goes up every year depending on, on what the price of oil is.
So the question should be, are you willing to put a cap on the gas tax?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Here is the answer to that same question from Chambers.
I'm glad you brought up the 2017 gas tax increase that Senator Braun supported. That would have been the largest tax increase in state history. But this is about the total palette of taxes. It's about income tax, property tax, gas tax, sales tax. Indiana is pretty competitive. We can always work to get that down over time without pulling the resources away from education and supporting our police and addressing mental health and health care. We have to look at the entire package of taxation in a package, not just one individual tax here and there. We do need to, we were number one in the country for infrastructure in 2022. We need to continue to make progress in infrastructure. And so we'd have to evaluate that in context of all other taxation. At the end of the day, we're number nine in the country. We'd like to get that down even further. But not at the expense of public safety or education as well.
So basically, nobody wants to do anything with the gas tax. That's what I took away from everybody on that stage last night.
And then what is the plan for lowering property taxes? Did we learn anything specific there? Because as far as I know, Jamie Rittenauer is the only one that has a specific plan for property taxes.
They talked about it.
They
said
it.
The words property tax,
right.
But nobody gave any sort of insight on how they were going to actually help. And hopefully our friends at Wish TV tonight can get to the bottom of some of these plans that everybody claims they have.
We'll follow up tomorrow for sure.
Matt Bear.
Looking at westbound 70 downtown, crash at West Street and two left lanes are blocked, stopping traffic into the south, putting back to Michigan Street on southbound 6570. Southbound 65 coming into downtown, stop and go traffic 29th and 2 Meridian Penn. Traffic sponsored by Mr. Quick Homes Services, now hiring. Mr. Quick is offering a paid apprenticeship to become a heating and AC technician, $17 an hour while learning a trade with six-figure earning potential. Class starts April 15th, register jobs. .com. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
It is a big day here on the Hammer and Nigel Show. Coming up at 4:35, the national championship game of Meltdown Madness.
Yes.
It all comes down to this today, the head-to-head matchup, all of the fanfare. That's coming up at 4:35. Right now, it's 41 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. This is the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Hammer and Nigel here, inviting you to join us as we kick off the weekend every Friday around 5:45 with Beer Sample Friday, brought to you by our friends at Thompson Furniture and Mattress in Columbus.
Hey guys, it's Rob. Did you know Universal Windows Direct does a lot more than just windows? You can get a new home at the same address with vinyl siding from Universal Windows Direct. Their exclusive Unishield Supreme siding delivers the warm, quality appearance of wood without the costly, time-consuming maintenance and repairs. But wait, Universal Windows Direct does even more. Make a great first impression and increase your home's curb appeal with a new entry door from Universal Windows Direct. Or how about this? Clogged gutters will cause major damage to your home, foundation problems, basement flooding, and more. With Universal Windows Direct, you'll never have to worry about cleaning your gutters again with their gutter protection system. Give your home a new glow. Call today at 317-659-7574 to schedule your free in-home estimate. And for every two windows you buy, you get the next two free. And tell them Rob Kendall told you to call and you'll get $250 off your project. Windows, siding, doors, gutters, and more. Universal Windows Direct, 317-659-7574.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online at hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation to determine the ED medication that's best for you. Discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and a range of treatment options, including trusted generic alternatives to the name brands, at up to 95% off. ED is personal, and at Hims, so is treating it. Just go to hims.com/joy and get connected to a licensed medical provider online for free. With zero copay, no expensive appointments, and no awkward face-to-face conversations. To start your free online visit, you need to go to this exclusive address, hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy for your free online visit, hims.com/joy.
Indy's biggest party is back. Miller Lite Carb Day, Friday, May 24th, featuring George Thorogood and the Destroyers. With special guests, Gin Blossoms. Anywhere you go, I'll follow you. Miller Lite Carb Day, May 24th at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. Concert, pit, and VIP tickets on sale now at IMS.com.
Why choose a Sleep Number smart bed?
Can it keep me warm when I'm cold?
Wait, no, I'm always hot.
Sleep Number does that. The Climate 360 smart bed actively cools or warms up to 13 degrees on either side for your ideal sleep temperature. 94% of Sleep Number smart sleepers report better sleep. J.D. Power ranks Sleep Number number one in customer satisfaction with mattresses purchased in-store. And now save $1,000 on our most popular Sleep Number smart bed and Saturday. For J.D. Power 2023 award information, visit jdpower.com/awards. To find a store near you, visit sleepnumber.com.
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Not that, huh? Indiana State moving on to the Final Four of the NIT after beating Cincinnati. Who's the tall, kind of goofy-looking guy with the rec specs?
Larry Nerd, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Robbie Avalai. He played well last night. Hit some big threes, sealing the game up for the Sycamores, and they move on to the Final Four of the NIT, which is at Hinkle Fieldhouse this year. So hopefully, good turnout for the Indiana State fans.
What about Purdue women's basketball? Would you happen to know off the top of your head about the NIT?
They are still playing in the NIT.
Yeah.
The Fighting Katie Geraldses.
That's right. Your cousin.
They're still playing in the NIT. And the IU women have moved on to the Sweet 16 of the Big Dance,
right,
the NCAA tournament, where I think they play the undefeated number one team in the country, South Carolina, next.
Oh, boy.
Now, obviously, all eyes are on Purdue men's team. Friday night in Detroit, taking on Gonzaga for a chance to go to the Elite Eight. If Purdue wins on Friday, they will then play on Sunday against the winner of Tennessee and Creighton. So some big games ahead, but
yeah, man,
we'll see what happens here. According to a new survey, Nige, 51% of Americans agree with the statement, "I think of my car as part of the family." Do you fall into the category of Americans who put their car in with the family?
My truck's got 180 some odd thousand miles on it. It's getting close to quitting time with this guy. And you know what? A small tear is going to roll down my cheek when I finally get rid of Blanche the Lanch.
Blanche the Lanch.
I got to drive an Avalanche.
And, okay.
I believe I bought it in the last. They don't make them anymore. So they might still be worth something. I don't know. But yeah, I'm close to being done. I just don't know what to do. Like after, like what the process is of buying a car. I haven't had to buy a car in 12 years. And I understand the process has completely changed.
Yeah.
In some respects anyway.
But there are a number of different places that make it easy.
Sure.
We bought our son's car from Ed Martin. They made the process really easy. Kathy, who I believe is part of the ownership there, she came by, talked to us. It was
she's great.
Easy peasy, man. What about you, Allison? Do you have anything, whether it's a pet, whether it's a car, that you consider part of the family?
Oh, I definitely consider all pets part of the family.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
Don't look at me like that.
Like, there's a difference between, like, but there's a difference between, like, loving your pet and thinking it's part of the family or being one of these crazy cat ladies.
I lean towards crazy cat ladies.
Do you really?
Yeah.
What do you have? What kind of?
I have two dogs. I have a pug and a French bulldog.
And do you talk in, like, the baby talk to them? Who's a good doggy? Who's a good doggy?
No, I just have normal conversations, you know, which may be worse.
The thing with pets is I think after we had two cats, one died a year ago, and after the other cat goes, no more. I can't take that kind of, you know, I can't take the awful emotion. And, you know, sitting there watching my daughter, my 9-year-old at the time, she was 8 at the time, devastated because one of the cats had a disease and the liver or whatever. I just can't go through that kind of emotional toll anymore. So,
but as they get older, it gets easier, I think.
My pet ownership as of Gary, who is my black cat that we have. After Gary goes, that's it. No more.
So we've had a few pets that have passed away.
Yeah.
We decided we wanted to get another cat because I think it helps scare the mice away in the house.
That is true.
More so, I think, than dogs. Like, we had two dogs, Sable and Foley. God love them. They were awesome. They were very protective of our kiddos when they were babies. Well, ultimately, they both passed away. And the kids, to their credit, thought it would be disrespectful to the memory of Sable and Foley to get replacement dogs. So we got replacement cats
sure.
Instead. 29 years ago, on this date, 1995, Forrest Gump beat Pulp Fiction and The Shawshank Redemption for Best Picture at the Academy Awards.
I agree with that assessment, even though Shawshank was amazing by director Frank Darabont. Forrest Gump was better. If I had to pick choice between the two, Forrest Gump probably better.
I know I'm in a super minority. I have never liked Pulp Fiction. Mm. I'm not a Tarantino guy, though. Like, to me, Pulp Fiction was dumb. It was boring. I couldn't get into it.
I understand why some people can't get into it. I loved it. I like Tarantino. I can't wait to see what the next movie is. But, like, what's a movie that everyone loves but you hate? You know, that's a good question. So I loved Pulp Fiction. I think, like, number three on that list, between Forrest Gump and Shawshank, that's third, in my opinion. But, like The Green Mile, by the same director, Frank Darabont, Shawshank.
Tom
Hanks film I didn't like. You know what? Every chick I dated in the early 2000s watched Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind by Jim Carrey.
Oh, that's a turd.
Oh, everybody loved that. And what do you, Allison, do you know what movie I'm talking about?
I do, and I liked it.
Oh.
It's a little slow,
I can't even remember. I can't even go back and really kind of conjure up what the movie was about.
Is it Serious Jim Carrey?
Yes. Yeah, it's serious.
It's serious, depressing Jim
Very
Carrey.
Depressing.
And then the other one that comes to mind was Black Swan with Natalie Portman, Darren Aronofsky.
Now, there's a scene in that movie, I believe, that I thought you would like. But in terms of the movie as a whole.
Yeah, turd.
So the question becomes, what is a movie that everybody else loves? They crap snowballs over, but you have never liked. Hit us up at Hammer and Nigel, Facebook, Twitter. We're on Instagram, the YouTube chat with the in-studio cameras. They're rocking and rolling right now. Find it. Jump in the chat. What is a movie everybody loves that you just never got into? At Hammer and Nigel.
Did you know that the tubs and showers installed by most bathroom remodelers aren't waterproof? I'm not kidding. They're not waterproof. That's because the other guys cheap out and put acrylic caulk directly on acrylic tub and shower panels. You can't do that. Water will seep through, and then you've got mold, mildew, and rot. To do it right, you have to first prime the surfaces, then apply the caulk, then you have to seal the caulk. It's a three-step process. Prime, apply, seal. If you've ever seen shower seams with mold growing on them, well, now you know why. Some cheapskate decided to save $25 in materials and 20 minutes of labor. And now you have a mold and mildew problem. Call Baths R Us instead. We never cut corners. We always take our time to do it right for a 100% waterproof installation every single time. Call now and get $1,500 off plus low to no monthly payments. Our number is 317-886-1761 or online at BathsRUs.com. That's BathsRUs.com.
Business. It's not a 9-to-5 proposition. It's all day and into the night. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these businesses is a partner like Comcast Business helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup in the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide, all these businesses choose the advanced network, cybersecurity solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business. From Main Street to Wall Street, our people are powering the businesses that power it all. So when you're ready to unlock what's possible for your business, there's no one better to answer the call. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
Restrictions apply. Call or visit ComcastBusiness.com to learn more.
Your home is your sanctuary. Get the peace of mind you deserve with a free estimate on a Generac automatic standby generator for your home from Generator Supercenter, the nation's number one Generac generator dealer. With expert installation and 24-hour monitoring, Generator Supercenter won't leave you in the dark. Financing is available. Take control of your power today with Generator Supercenter. Call 317-827-0808. Generator Supercenter of Indianapolis, 317-827-0808.
93 WIPC Mobile News, on the level, on the go.
They're still missing. Mostly cloudy at 41 degrees on Monument Circle. You've got a clear radar. Low of 30 expected tonight with mostly clear skies. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 3:32. Six construction workers who were on the Francis Scott Key Bridge when it collapsed yesterday are still missing and presumed to be dead.
Work is undergoing to recover their remains, and our thoughts and prayers are with their loved ones whose lives are never going to be the same.
Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg, he says the U.S. Coast Guard and the Army Corps of Engineers are working on cleanup. Investigators say the ship had issued a Mayday warning after it lost power before running into a support on the bridge. And that Baltimore bridge collapse will cause supply chain shortages, mainly affecting the automotive industry, according to Amy David, a supply chain management professor with Purdue.
Baltimore is not one of the largest ports on the East Coast, but it is special in that a lot of cars and light trucks are brought in through Baltimore.
David says car dealers in Indiana will deal with delays importing cars from overseas due to the pandemic's impact on inventory. The United States still negotiating over freeing hostages being held by Hamas.
We do think it's possible to bridge those differences, and we're going to continue to try to bridge those differences because we think a ceasefire that secures the release of hostages would be in the interests of the United States, in the interests of Israel, and in the interests of the broader region.
State Department spokesperson Matthew Miller. Israel says they're still planning to invade the city of Rafah despite the U.S. warning about possible civilian casualties. Over $22,000 of baby formula was stolen from a Walmart in southern Indiana. Wes Woodward reports there were a few more stores involved.
That larger theft ring includes items taken from Walmarts in Boonville, Newburgh, Evansville, and Jasper, Indiana. Boonville police were dispatched to Walmart Thursday to investigate stolen baby formula. The suspect's vehicle was stopped less than a mile away from the store with a large amount of baby formula in the vehicle. Arrested were Edgar Ramirez and Nora Zarate. A third juvenile suspect from Texas was also taken into custody for their role in the incident. Investigators found 576 containers of baby formula totaling close to $22,500. The pair are both facing felony charges for theft. Wes Woodward, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 3:34.
Your new car, your new truck, your new electric vehicle is at Andy Moore Ford in Plainfield because they've got the deal that can't be beat. All of the new cars and trucks you're looking for and electric vehicles like the all-electric F-150 Lightning with seating up to 5, intelligent backup power, and on-site power for all your tools and gear. This all-electric truck is built for it all. Andy Moore Ford also has the rebates for you. Federal and state incentives. You could save more on your EV purchase, up to $7,500 instantly on site, and save more on all of their cars and trucks, their fleet vehicles, and their electric vehicles. Andy Moore Ford in Plainfield, including more to your door. You can just buy the car online and they will deliver it directly to you. Andy Moore Ford. Visit them on Main Street in Plainfield or online at andymooreford.com. That's Andy Moore, M-O-H-R. I love Andy. andymooreford.com.
The traffic at 3:35. What's going on, Matt Bear?
All right, Harry, looking at downtown crash westbound as 70 West Street crash blocking the left lane. Two left lanes are blocked now. It stopped back into the south split and slowing traffic back into the north split. Also stopping traffic after Rural Street into the north split. Southbound 65 jammed up MLK to Meridian Penn. Traffic sponsored by Royal Spa. Everyone knows that soaking in Epsom salts can make you feel better. Now imagine soaking in Epsom salts in a Royal Spa hot tub. RoyalSpa.com. Royal Spa. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Clouds begin to decrease later on today, so some sunshine, but it still stays cool. Highs near 48. Clear skies tonight. Areas of frost developing with lows near 32. I'm Wish TV storm tracking meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the level on the go and on WIBC.com.
Crime, punishment, judges, legal stuff.
I have to tell you, Hammer, I'm sort of relieved I haven't heard anything about the pending Delphi murder trial in a week or two. Because, you know, no news is good news as far as I'm concerned. Because it sounded like chaos there leading up to the trial of Richard Allen for his alleged murders of Libby and Abby. And so we're a couple of months away from this trial, and we haven't heard anything until now.
Now we've got an update. A new defense attorney will be joining the defense team of Richard Allen, but in a limited capacity. So in a filing that was submitted earlier today, defense attorney Jennifer Auger will join the team of attorneys that are going to be representing Richard Allen, but Jennifer will be working in some sort of limited capacity. The court documents say that she will assist the attorneys with, quote, matters related to the service of process and future depositions of FBI agents associated with the investigation.
Okay. Don't know what that means. Sounds pretty complicated and official, but I'm just, did what I say make sense though? Like, I'm just, we were hearing it was day after day after day of accusations of, you know, leaking documents, and then prosecution was, you know, charging, wanting the judge to charge the defense with contempt.
There was a fight in the courthouse.
Yeah, there was between two YouTubers that were going to get called to the stand. The defense doesn't trust the judge, wants her to step down. I'm tired of it. Let's get this thing on and so we can get some justice for Libby and Abby, hopefully.
First thing I thought of, and again, this is the way my mind works. Anytime a TV show adds a new character, it stinks. So I'm wondering if this is actually going to be beneficial to the defense or not. You know, is this going to be like a great addition like Woody was to the cast of Cheers? Or is this going to be like that little rotten redheaded kid with the freckles that ruined Different Strokes? Thanks for ruining Different Strokes, you little mutant.
I forgot about that kid. That was towards obviously towards the end of the show, right?
Yeah, that was like a thing for a while. TV shows that were trying to reinvigorate their audience that they lost, they would try to put in a new kid. Cousin Oliver on the Brady Bunch. Oh, awful. They tried to bring in a new kid on Growing Pains. Awful. I think Full House tried to pump out a few new kids. Sucked every time. but nobody was worse than that little mutant that totally ruined Different Strokes.
Oh, wow.
Check this out. Apparently, you can get busted with $1 million in coke and 47 grand in cash and be out on bond the next night. This was something I did not know.
In Indy?
Correct. A Florida truck driver charged with moving $1 million in cocaine from L.A. to Indy has been released on bond from Putnam County. 41-year-old Miami resident Yanir Pina Machado, if you like Pina Machados and all his cocaine, should have made a Hammer and Nigel Records song there. He was arrested last week after the state police pulled him over and they found $1.1 million worth of illegal drugs and 47 grand in cash in his truck. But he paid $40,000 cash bond and he is out. Now, he's been given a date for a pretrial conference, May 22nd, 2024. So my question to you, Nige, what are the chances that Pina Machado shows up to that pretrial hearing?
I'd say zero. How in the world do you get caught with that much China, as they say? Coke.
Colombian Bam Bam.
Yeah, and you're gone the next day? How do you make the bail? Who's making that bail for you? If you're detectives, and by the way, he was on as the paperwork for his itinerary said he was supposed to make it a delivery somewhere in Illinois. And when the police pulled him over, this guy was all nervous and shaking and acting real suspicious. And he was 200 miles away from where his itinerary or whatever.
He missed his delivery by 200 miles.
Yeah, right. Exactly. And so, I mean, if you're a detective, don't you want to sit this guy down? I mean, there's got to, what's the bail matrix in Putnam County? That's like Cloverdale, right? That's near, southern Putnam County. I'm flummoxed. I'm perplexed. Don't you want to know where the drugs come from? Who's your guy? Where did you get him? Who's posting bond?
I need somebody in law enforcement to help me out. If you pull somebody over and they've got that much blow and that much cash, and I'm pretty sure the cash they've made from selling the blow, can they use that cash to bail themselves out?
No way.
How are they allowed to use the coke money to bail themselves
honestly,
out?
Honestly, people caught with weed in their car go to jail for the night and then get out the next day. This guy was caught with $1 million worth of coke.
And 45 pounds of weed.
And he's out the next day. Nobody knows his whereabouts. All we know is that he has to be back for a court date at the end of May. No way he shows up.
They said he had $47,000 in cash. Did he use more cash to bail himself out?
That's what I'm saying. This guy's connected somehow. I'm sure investigators would have loved to have sat down and maybe questioned this guy.
If you like selling weed at midnight, doing coke in the rain.
Pina Machado. I mean, I guess my question is, I mean, the guy needs a lawyer probably. You can't question him without a lawyer. But there has to be some sort of, bail was only $40,000?
Right. For $1 million worth of drugs.
I'm scratching my head. At Hammer and Nigel if somebody wants to explain that.
Doing some legal stuff here. Let's go down to Florida. The ultimate Florida man, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis, has approved new state law prohibiting minors under the age of 14 from using social media and mandating 14 and 15-year-olds and those below have to get parental consent before they log in. Now, this isn't just for TikTok. This is for Twitter, X, whatever you want to call it, Instagram, Facebook, all of it. What do you think?
I don't know how they're going to implement that. How are they going to control that? How are they going to, what's the age verification look like? And is it going to be somewhere, we were talking about this off the air. I believe it was you that said, when I get on a beer website, like a craft beer site, it has to make sure I'm 21.
Right.
And it just says, are you 21, yes or no? And you click yes.
Right. Well,
but that doesn't do anything. You're not verifying anybody's age. My 10-year-old can get on the same site.
Right. Remember years ago, if you bought like illegal fireworks in the state of Indiana, you had to sign this waiver that says you're going to take them to Kentucky and blow them up or take them out of state
you
and blow them up.
You will not light these in state.
Right. So ridiculous. I'm wondering if it's something similar to that. The Florida lawmaker, though, who wrote the bill says, quote, "The internet has become a dark alley for our children where predators target them and dangerous social media leads to higher rates of depression, self-harm, and even suicide."
And that's where the parents come in to monitor that. I have a 12-year-old and a 10-year-old. They're not on social media. They won't be for a while.
So for those kids in Florida that feel like they're not going to be able to post on social media because they're underage, perhaps the book that we came out with could help them out. Oh.
New from Hammer and Nigel. Are you a social media loser? Not enough likes on Facebook? Nobody seems to care when you post a stupid selfie of you and your dog? Well, Hammer and Nigel have the answer. Vague booking for dummies. That's right. Vague booking for dummies. If you're not getting the attention you deserve on Facebook, just post an intentionally vague status update, then sit back and watch the flood of concern pour in. It's real simple. All you need is a couple of words and a few punctuation marks at the end. For example, the one-word post.
Devastated. Dot, dot, dot.
The religious post.
Prayers needed. Dot, dot, dot.
Reminder, never say why prayers are needed.
The philosophical post.
What's the point? Question mark, question mark, question mark.
There's even vague booking for millennials.
I literally just can't even right now. Dot, dot, dot.
If you're an attention whore that loves when people ask what's wrong, you need vague booking for dummies. Don't forget about the regretful post.
I should have known better. Dot, dot, dot.
And our personal favorite, the emotional song lyric post. So
I'm sorry for everything that I've done, but when I call, you never seem to be home. Dot, dot, dot.
Vague booking for dummies from Hammer and Nigel, available everywhere.
I can't believe you're gone. Dot, dot, dot.
Yes!
It's a bestseller.
It's going to be a big seller in Florida.
Hey, it's Big Joe for Absolute Comfort. Trusted independent American Standard Air dealer. Owner Chris Wedekin sells the ductless Mitsubishi Electric Mini Split, which is a clean and extremely energy efficient way to heat and cool a specific area.
These systems don't run the air through the ductwork, which is where a lot of your dust and allergies and other displeasing smells come from. And maybe best of all, you're not circulating viruses throughout the home.
Find out more at absolutecomfort.org. Absolute Comfort is your trusted independent American Standard Air Mitsubishi Electric Elite Ductless Pro dealer.
Why is the $29 tune-up special from Broad Ripple Service Experts such a big deal? You save $100 and they could save your AC. Broad Ripple Service Experts can help restore your AC's reliability and extend its life, saving you up to 30% on energy bills and keeping your equipment warranty valid. And their service is 100% guaranteed. Broad Ripple Service Experts is all about making you feel right at home. Get total home comfort with their $29 tune-up. Call 866-EXPERTS today. License numbers HL110009 and PC1990002.
Gravely's Mow the Distance sales event is back. Now through April 8th, you can save up to 25% with special financing available on America's most rugged mowers, including the Gravely ZT-HD. It's the residential mower built to commercial standards with the power, durability, and high performance Gravely is known for. With a Gravely, you can count on more comfort, more speed, and more precision. But hurry, these special Mow the Distance savings are only available through April 8th and only at your authorized Gravely dealer.
Indiana Pathways for Aging helps Hoosier Medicaid members age 60 and over get support at no additional cost to live life their way.
Mom's Parkinson's is progressing, and Pathways provides in-home support so she can be with family every day.
Pathways coordinates Medicaid and Medicare services. I'm getting help with meals, personal care, and transportation.
One day, I might choose a nursing home, but today, I have options with Pathways.
Eligible members can select a plan now. Call 87-PATHWAY-4 or visit in.gov/pathways.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Woodard Emhart, Henry Reeves, and Wagner. Over 140 years specializing exclusively in patent, trademark, trade secret, and copyright law and litigation. On the web at USPatent.com.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Matt Baer has a look at the roads.
Yeah, a hammer band crash on the east side. It is southbound 465, just south of I-70. And right now, three left lanes are blocked. Traffic getting by on the far right side. That is it. And traffic is stopped back to East 30th Street. That's past the I-70 interchange. Not quite the Penn Pike yet. A delay time has opened up just shy of a half hour. Looking at southbound 6570, still stopped from the north split to the south split. This is because of a crash going westbound 70, like downtown to the airport. Westbound 70 at West Street, blocking the left lane. And again, stop traffic all the way back to the north split and onto westbound 70. Traffic sponsored by Indy Decorative Concrete, Indy's leader in patio installation, is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
43 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center at 93 WIBC.
I drive these brothers crazy. I do it on the day. They treat me really nicely.
Fergie?
Fergie Ferg.
If you need a reason to drink tonight, Fergie is 49 years old.
Damn, Fergie's pushing 50 now?
Can I tell you, I met Fergie when I was doing afternoons here on this signal when it was Radio Now 93.1 backstage. She was playing some show at the Murat Theater. And it was such a weird experience because, like, this was at the height of her fame. Like, really, really famous. Really just, I mean, we were playing her songs hour after hour after hour. And so I show up, and I'm thinking there's going to be all this security. I'm going to jump through all these hoops trying to get backstage to interview her, right? So I knock on the side door of the facility there, the Murat, and the guy goes, hey, yeah? I go, yeah, Nigel, Radio Now, here to interview Fergie. He's like, yeah, come on in. And then he leads me backstage, and there's a manager or something outside her door, and I go, yeah, I'm supposed to interview Fergie, Nigel from Radio Now. He's like, oh, yeah, go on in. I go, do I have to knock? He goes, nah, just go on in. And I walk in there, and she turns around, and she's eating cottage cheese. I go, hi, Fergie, I'm Nigel. I'm here for the interview. You know, it's kind of nervous, actually. I don't know what this. She was totally down to earth, coolest chick.
Really?
One of the best interviews I've ever done, I think. I wish I could find it.
Was she fully dressed?
She was fully dressed,
That's
yeah.
a shame.
And there's a picture of us somewhere. Maybe I could try to find it. Her and I took a picture of the cottage cheese that she was eating together. Like, she was eating out of the actual tub of cheese.
Telling you, man, she's 49, but she's still got her fastball. She's still an attractive woman. I don't care what you think about her music, but she's hot. She's still got
it. Don't you think that's weird that I was able to get back there so, fast, sort of lackadaisical?
What if some stranger would have said, I'm Nigel? Went back there and hit her with a bat or something, right?
I love that our manager said, I go, I was trying to be professional. Do you want me to knock? He's like, nah, it's going in.
It's Fergie. She was married to that dude from the Las Vegas TV show, Josh Duhamel, for a long time. I don't think they're married anymore.
He's a good-looking man.
Yeah, that's a good-looking couple. So if you need a reason to drink tonight, Fergie is 49. Great moments in Fergie history, aside from the interview with Nigel, this was the 2019 NBA All-Star Game. She sang the national anthem.
Ooh.
For the land of the free. And the home of the brave. Let's play some basketball!
And the best part about that is the camera, you know, it's going down the line of all the All-Stars. They're trying not to laugh. Draymond Green just breaks out. He starts cracking up.
It wasn't the worst rendition of the anthem I've ever heard.
No, there's some strange
parts in that, though, for sure.
And that was just like the last part. I didn't play the first 7 minutes. I mean, it was a long rendition of the national anthem. Great moments in Fergie history. I think this counts because we like cover songs on this program. This is when Alanis Morissette covered My Humps.
What you gonna do with all that ass inside them jeans? I'm gonna make you scream, make you scream, make you scream.
into that?
I really like the version in Blades of Glory better when Will Ferrell was doing it.
He's walking on the treadmill.
Yeah. I like that version a whole hell of a lot better.
Blades of Glory, underrated film. Nobody's ever going to say that's their favorite Will Ferrell movie. And when you think of John Heder, it's Napoleon Dynamite. Yeah. But he was pretty good in that, too. All right, where are we at with this? Ice Cube, former rapper, actor. Now he runs that Big Three basketball league, right?
He just won some huge award for that, too. Yeah.
He is now saying that the Big Three basketball league has made an offer to Caitlin Clark, $5 million, to join his Big Three basketball league and not play in the WNBA for the Fever, most likely.
Yeah. Caitlin Clark, I mean, again, one of the best basketball players ever in the history of women's college sports. Broke the all-time scoring record, men and women. I think she's going to be able to make a ton of money on endorsements. And to be affiliated with the NBA and the WNBA is probably something. I'm not saying Ice Cube's doing bad. That league's doing very well.
And it's fun to watch. If you've ever been laying around on the couch on a Sunday, you know, it's like older NBA dudes that are a bit washed, but they take it seriously.
It just seems like it's more of a novelty than a pro sports league.
Right.
She wants to go to go play with the best in the world.
Her
brand
can grow with the marketing machine of the NBA behind them.
Yeah.
Because that's who runs the WNBA. All right. Coming up here in just about 30 minutes, it is on like Donkey Kong, the finals of Meltdown Madness. All month long, the tournament has been leading toward this. That is coming up in just a little bit. Do not go anywhere. This is the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Denny Smith here from my friends at Sundown Gardens in Westfield. The nursery's stocking up for a big spring. How about you come shop to see their early selection at Sundown Gardens in Westfield? You'll be happy you did. Sundown Gardens wants to make sure you have all the best Easter decor, and this week, all Easter decor is 50% off in the garden shop. Happy Easter from Sundown Gardens. Sundown Gardens is at 186th Street and Spring Mill Road in Westfield. SundownGardens.com. Sundown Gardens is closed on Easter Sunday.
Let Bill Estes put you behind the wheel of the powerhouse brands that define American toughness. Ford, Chevy, Ram, and GMC.
Right now, save up to 17% off new 2024 Ram 1500s.
Unleash the power of the road with Bill Estes Trucks. Find the location near you and see their inventory at BillEstesTrucks.com.
All rebates and incentives included in final discounts. Stock number BCJ240027. TRX models excluded from all offers. See dealer for details.
Hi, it's Bob from Royal Spa. Soaking in a hot tub full of Epsom salts is the absolute best way to minimize everyday aches and pains. And we know all about Epsom salts at Royal Spa. Royal Spa hot tubs are the only hot tubs on the market that can safely and effectively use Epsom salts. Made right here in Indiana, Royal Spa hot tubs are the highest quality hot tubs on the market. Visit any one of our 3 Indianapolis locations or visit royalspa.com.
Ah, Royal Spa.
Life insurance. Why are you putting it off? Can't afford it? Too much hassle? Think you don't need it? There's lots of excuses for putting off life insurance. But if you weren't there, who would pay the mortgage and other bills? With Ethos, you could be covered in 10 minutes and boom, family protected. Ethos, fast and easy online term life insurance. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as a dollar a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at getethos.com. That's getethos.com.
Did you know one of the best investments you can make? It's in yourself. At My Computer Career, in just a few months, you could start your new career in the high-demand, recession-resistant field of information technology. Isn't it time you invest in you and start a career in networking, cybersecurity, AI, or upskill to boost your current IT career? So, get the ROI you deserve at My Computer Career. No experience necessary. Start now at mycomputercareer.edu.
Financial aid is available for qualified students, including the GI Bill.
You expect your home to protect everything you love, but you don't expect the ways water is breaking down your basement and damaging your home. Mold, cracks, and of course visible water are just a few signs your basement is compromised. But there's one way to get answers to all your concerns. A free home inspection from Indiana Foundation Service. We put water back in its place. Get your free inspection at indianafoundation.com.
Head to the contest page at WIBC.com and register to win a pair of tickets to see Andrea Bocelli with the Indianapolis Symphony Orchestra, Saturday, April 13th at Gainbridge Fieldhouse.
Coming up in 2 minutes, how the bridge collapse in Baltimore yesterday could wind up impacting Indiana, why someone from Nebraska was arrested in the Hoosier State, and a debate that every Republican governor candidate plans to be at. All that and more coming up after Fox News Radio from the Technology Recycler Studios. You're listening to 93 WIBC, WIBC HD1 Indianapolis. It's 4 o'clock.
From the White House, I'm Lisa Brady, Fox News. On day two of the search for six construction workers now presumed dead after the Key Bridge collapsed early yesterday in Baltimore.
Work is undergoing to recover their remains, and our thoughts and prayers are with their loved ones whose lives are never going to be the same.
Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg not giving any estimate on how long it will take to remove the cargo ship that hit the bridge and reopen the port of Baltimore.
The NTSB is reviewing the black box from that cargo ship as well as interviewing the people on that ship, trying to piece together what happened the moments before it collided with the bridge. The next step is cleanup and rebuilding, trying to get the Baltimore port open, the bridge debris cleaned up, and a new bridge rebuilt because the people that live here depend on it.
Fox Business's Hillary Vaughn in Baltimore. It's also a global problem with the port serving as a critical lifeline for the coal and auto industries, GM and Ford rerouting their cars and trucks, many other businesses facing the same issue. The U.S. isn't giving up its push for a new ceasefire and hostage deal between Israel and Hamas.
We remain hopeful that we can broker a deal to secure the release of hostages and establish a temporary ceasefire. This is something that we've been asking for some time.
White House spokeswoman Karine Jean-Pierre also says there is an agreement for Israeli officials to come to Washington and discuss military plans in the city of Rafah. It's being rescheduled after the prime minister canceled a delegation this week when the U.S. allowed a U.N. Security Council resolution calling for a Gaza ceasefire to pass. Prime Minister Netanyahu says that encouraged Hamas to take a hard line, and he pulled the delegation to send a message that international pressure won't work. Netanyahu meeting today with U.S. senators in Jerusalem, including Lindsey Graham, who calls destruction of Hamas battalions in Rafah non-negotiable. A rally on Wall Street, the Dow up 478 at the bell. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
Hopefully, you're not in the market for a new car. Mostly cloudy, 43 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. No rain on your radar. You'll have a low of about 30 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 402. Because of the bridge collapse in Baltimore, you could expect shortages of vehicles at car dealerships across the states. Ryan Hedrick reports.
Purdue business professor Amy David predicts a supply chain shortage as Baltimore's port has closed. She says car imports from Europe and the Middle East will be delayed. However,
it may actually be an opportunity for some of the car makers that are in the Midwest or locally to gain a little bit of market share.
David says fewer European cars available mean Hoosier-based dealerships can attract customers who typically opt out of European brands. Ryan Hedrick, 93 WIBC, Mobile News.
Former South Bend mayor and current transportation secretary Pete Buttigieg praised the response from Maryland's government during the bridge collapse.
Governors responded to this unthinkable event with focus and compassion, and we're going to be working closely with him and with his state's DOT to support Maryland in their work to rebuild the bridge and reopen the port.
Six construction workers presumed to be dead still haven't been found. A car was stolen in Nebraska and it wound up crashing in Indiana, reports Sam Fritz.
On Tuesday, the Greensburg Police Department was monitoring a suspicious Chevrolet in a Walmart parking lot when the vehicle fled south onto East Nightingale Street. The Chevrolet would exit the parking lot through a grass ditch and end up hitting another car. Drivers from both vehicles would end up with serious injuries. The man who fled was later identified as Shane Rager of Nebraska. It turns out he had multiple warrants for his arrest involving theft. That includes the Chevrolet that ended up in the accident, which had been reported stolen. Sam Fritz, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
The final GOP gubernatorial debate has been scheduled for April 23rd on IUPUI's campus. All six Republican candidates plan to be at Hine Hall Auditorium that night. They answer questions starting at 7. You can be in the audience if you'd like. Also, our news gathering partner, Wish TV, has the debate tonight. The average price you're paying for a gallon of gas in Indiana, $3.47. That's according to GasBuddy.com. It's also 6 cents below the national average. Traffic and weather in 60 seconds. Your time is 4:04.
Your nose is for breathing. Your mouth is for eating. And if you're breathing through your mouth, it's not because your body wants to. It's because it has to, because your nose isn't working properly. And although you've lived like this, it's no way to live, and it's having a significant impact on your life. I know you know this, and I know that taking action isn't always convenient. But at Advent, we've done all we can to make changing your life for the better as easy as possible. I'm Dr. Madan Kandula. With tens of thousands of our patients, a thorough breathing triangle evaluation, along with a simple 20-minute in-office procedure called balloon sinuplasty, has opened their nasal passages, allowing them to breathe freely through their nose for good. And there's a good chance this procedure can do the same for you. We'll help you breathe through your nose again, and it will change your life.
Go to AdventNose.com to schedule your appointment, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Results may vary.
Traffic on the 5s at 4:05. What's going on, Matt Bear?
Harrison on the east side, crash southbound 465 after I-73. Left lanes are blocked and traffic is stopped. Back to Penn Pike. Delay time now 31 minutes. Look at this southbound 65. Stop and go traffic from 21st to Meridian Penn. Crash clear downtown. Westbound 70 of West Street. We are still slow from the south split past West Street. Eastbound 70 slow to downtown from Belmont to Meridian, Illinois. Traffic sponsor by Freegee and Freegee Auctioneers. Join Freegee Auctioneers for the Spring Midwest Construction and Farm Public Auction on Thursday, April 4th in Clayton. Bid live on site or online at buyfreegee.com. License AC31200002. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Clouds begin to decrease later on today, so some sunshine, but it still stays cool. Highs near 48. Clear skies tonight. Areas of frost developing with lows near 32. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the level on the go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Do you believe these characters are weirdos?
So let's rock it!
My name is Nigel. Over there, quick update on the response from the Baltimore Bridge Dispatch that helped save the lives by quickly communicating that all the traffic had to be stopped on both sides of the Key Bridge. Remember yesterday, early yesterday morning, a cargo ship got out of control. The engine died, the power went out, and it ended up hitting a pillar across that bridge. It collapsed the whole bridge like a load of toothpicks. Just incredible footage. They're still looking for, well, they're not looking for them anymore. They're trying to recover them. They pretty much pronounced the six construction workers dead. Here is the dramatic communication as they work on that as soon as they heard that there was a problem with the cargo ship.
I need one of you guys on the south side, one of you guys on the north side, hold all traffic on the Key Bridge. There's a ship approaching. I just lost their steering. So that until they get that under control, we got to stop all traffic.
I'm en route to the south side.
Yeah, if we can stop traffic, just make sure no one's on the bridge right now. There's a crew up there. You might want to notify whoever the foreman is, see if we can get them off the bridge temporarily.
10-4, once the other unit gets here, I'll ride up on the bridge.
C-13 dispatch, the whole bridge just fell down. Everybody, the whole bridge just collapsed.
Do we know if all traffic will stop?
I can't get to the other side, sir. The bridge is down.
C-13, I'm holding all traffic northbound.
Yeah, so again, dramatic audio there. The bridge is down, but you heard that Mayday, or the cargo ship was calling for Mayday, Mayday, Mayday. And then you heard the guy say, all right, get people on both sides of that bridge to shut that traffic down. And so far, and I think it's pretty much confirmed, imagine how many lives they saved.
Right.
I mean, because there were dozens of cars on that bridge going back and forth as the cargo ship was headed out of control towards that pillar.
How would you feel if you were one of those vehicles that were the last one across?
Oh, we've got, I mean, I'm sure the news is working on who these people were, right? I'm sure they're, I would love to hear their story. I would love to, yeah, the very last across. Because then you see, you watch the thing in slow motion, you watch it in real time, the cars stop. So these guys that were working, these first responders and whoever this, you know, dispatch there, the Baltimore Bridge dispatch saved untold amount of lives. And it sucks. It's horrible that, six construction workers just doing their job, dangerous right. job, filling potholes at night. They do it at night because during the day there's about 30,000 to 35,000 cars that use that bridge. It's just awful that they, you know, six lives lost now because of an accident. Look, I'm seeing, I don't know about you, I'm seeing a lot of conspiracy theories on social media.
And a lot of new bridge experts, bridge safety, construction yeah. experts. Now, listen, if you are somebody that is legitimately in construction and can explain this to me like I'm five, I'm open ears. Because it is kind of wild to see this cargo ship hit this one pillar and then the whole bridge just falls in. Like, is that normal? It looks like one of those coordinated implosions you see of stadiums where everything kind of goes off and everything falls in. It was wild. Is that normal? Is that what's supposed to happen if a cargo ship of this magnitude hits a pillar like that?
Well, look, it's not unprecedented. I'll tell you that. I mean, you go back to 1980, the Skyway collapse for what is now Interstate 275. Same thing happened. 35 people died in that out-of-control cargo ship, hit a pillar there in Tampa. And, I mean, this is 1980, but it's not unprecedented. So, yeah, you and I think both have traveled 275 south before.
Right.
Of course, it's completely rebuilt and everything, but it's not unprecedented.
We've got a little feud, so Allison, cue up the band. So, this happened on a North Carolina radio station, 99.3 WBT, the news talk station in Charlotte. White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre. Allison, give me the laugh.
Ha ha.
We need one more ha. It's three.
You
ha ha ha.
Made up for it with the extra one.
That was four. Wait a minute. I only needed three.
So she was a guest on this radio program. I guess Joe Biden's going to North Carolina. It's a swing state. So they head on, ha, 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 to be a guest. Well, Karine didn't like the questioning of these radio hosts, specifically the news director, Mark Garrison, and she hangs up on the guys. Take a listen.
When I told a number of people that I was talking to you today, it was interesting, though. They all said, would you please just ask her? Does the president have dementia? And so before I move on from that, does he?
That Mark, I can't even believe you're asking me this question. That is a incredibly offensive question to ask.
But you know people ask it.
No. You're taking us down this rabbit hole. Let me be very clear about this. For the past several years, the president's physician has laid out in a comprehensive way the president's health. You know, take the premise of your question. I think it is incredibly insulting, and so we can move on to the next question.
Gas prices and grocery prices, then, big topics here in North Carolina. How does Mr. Biden win votes when people don't have as much disposable income?
Now you're asking me about gas prices. The president took action on gas prices. Let's not forget Russia's invasion on Ukraine skyrocketed prices of gas, and because the president took action, we're in a different place than we were a year ago on gas prices. Eggs, milk, seafood products, all the important groceries, those costs have gone down because of what this president has been able to do. And with that, thank you so much, Mark. Have an amazing, amazing day.
Wow. Wow.
She hung up.
Wow.
So the White House press secretary apparently is soft as a baby's ass. You can't take a couple questions from a radio host? How do you stand at that podium every single day and do your job, but you can't handle that?
She's been asked that question a million times. I guess her point was she can't, as the White House, as Biden's spokesman, lend any credence whatsoever that the president has dementia. So even answering the question is kind of legitimizing the question a little bit. And look, it's her job. I mean, she's right. Trying to spin it. We all know. We can see the signs. We all have had grandparents or relatives with the same signs that we see Joe Biden acting out every day. The thing with the grocery store prices, that comment afterwards, Hammer, wait, is she joking? Grocery store prices are through the roof.
And that's why she hung up right away, because she didn't want to have any follow-up questions. Like, I don't know who these radio hosts are, but I would hope they would have pushed back a little bit saying,
yeah, that was interesting.
Wait a minute, you don't get to say prices are down when you were the one that set it at a record high. It's still substantially higher than when, your words, your predecessor was there. So, yeah, that was some interesting radio there. One more time, mood music, Allison. Dateline, Washington State. The state of Washington now has a stripper's bill of rights, Nigel.
Really?
And you know what? I'm actually on board with this.
Okay.
I think this is good legislation.
What are we looking at here?
The new law requires training for employees in strip clubs and establishments like that to prevent sexual harassment, identify and report any human trafficking, de-escalate conflict, and provide first aid. It also mandates security workers on site all the time, keypad codes on the dressing rooms, and panic button where the strippers may be alone with customers.
Oh, the champagne room, huh?
Right. So, listen, my experiences as a younger man in the strip club, all positive. I never had anything scary or bad happen. But some of these girls will tell you, these dudes are awful. Some of these dudes are awful to them that go to the clubs.
They get paid for.
It is, but they don't get paid to get sexually harassed, beaten, and threatened in the parking lot.
Yeah. And there's a difference.
And that's what this stripper's bill of rights is about. And now with the rise of human trafficking, these types of establishments, these strip clubs, they're kind of a hotbed for transactions. So maybe now with a little training, the staff, the girls, the security guards, they can kind of help better keep an eye on everybody.
I will say, I mean, the Red Garter's been down here forever, downtown. Do they need state mandates? Because it seems like they're doing an awfully good job. You know, do you need the state coming in and mandating things, I guess is what I'm saying, because they've been around forever. They obviously know what they're doing. It's a longtime institution. Whether morally you agree with it or not, that's not the point of this conversation. I'm just saying the people that run it obviously kind of know what they're doing because it's been around forever.
But you know what, though? It feels like this is the broad ripple conversation. The people who have their act together, this isn't going to affect you because you're probably doing these things already. It's the people that don't want to pay attention by the rules, the people that are a pain in the ass, that are making it bad for everybody else. So maybe this is where that comes in. And speaking of strippers, it seems like only yesterday that Phil Collin of Def Leppard called into this show. And we asked him, hey, you know that song, Pour Some Sugar on Me, it kind of became a strip club anthem. And he shared this little anecdote. Phil, when you wrote Pour Some Sugar on Me and you guys performed Pour Some Sugar on Me, did you ever in your wildest dreams imagine that this song would still be a strip club anthem 30 years later?
That's crazy. 30 years is insane. But we knew it had a, you know, it kicked off. It got its birth in the strip clubs. You know, we'd released the album. We had two or three singles that done okay, not great. And then the strippers started requesting this song on local radio in Florida. And that's really how it kicked off. And it becomes so popular, everyone's going, well, why is this song on all these Florida radio stations? And that was all these girls, these strippers, were actually kind of requesting it.
Emily tweets at us, at Hammer and Nigel, in regards to the stripper bill of rights. Glad to hear that Rob Kendall's going to be safe when he's up on stage. Thank you, Emily. All right, Matt Baer, what's going on?
East Side Crash, southbound 465 after I-73. 70. Two left lanes are blocked and traffic is jammed up. Back past Pendleton Pike almost to East 56th Street. Delayed time if you're at the back of the line is 35 minutes. Also, a crash on the south side is South Meridian, State Road 135, just south of Bantha Road. That's at Loretta Drive. Eastbound 70 stop and go to downtown for Belmont. Traffic sponsored by the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. Guys, solve your ED today with an intimacy guarantee only at the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. If you don't perform, you don't pay. Call the Indianapolis Men's Clinic at 999-9000. That's 999-9000. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
44 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. We are just about 15 minutes away from Meltdown Madness, the finals. But first, we'll do Is This Anything? And that's next.
This is the most exciting time of the year, and we want you to go all the way, even if your team doesn't. March on, Indiana, in a Hubler quality pre-owned vehicle. Shop any of Hubler's 12 locations and choose from over 1,000 vehicles. Chevys, Fords, GMCs, Buicks, Nissans, Acuras, Mazdas, Hondas, and many more. All makes, all models, certified vehicles, luxury vehicles, even the hard-to-find ones. Every Hubler Q-certified vehicle is covered by a 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty, plus a 128-point vehicle inspection and a free Carfax history report. Hubler's got you covered for 100,000 miles. Busted brackets not included. So what drives Indiana? DriveHubler.com. For over 1,000 vehicles, visit any of our 12 locations. Hubler's got you covered. Come away. Warranty on select models less than 9 years old.
Jefferson Shreve stepped up to fight when no one else would. He put it all on the line. And the liberals smeared him for it with ads like this.
Donald Trump and Jefferson Shreve. He's an original supporter of Donald Trump.
They attacked Shreve for being a conservative.
Jefferson Shreve, an A rating from the NRA.
Attacked him for being a loyal Republican.
Look who was there, Jefferson Shreve. He was proud to be on the Trump campaign and proud of his own A rating from the NRA.
All because Shreve would get tough, back the blue, and stop the crime. But we don't have to accept their lawlessness at our border, in our suburbs, in our state. Because Jefferson Shreve is running for Congress, and he's a fighter for law, order, and a secure border. Jefferson Shreve for Congress.
I'm Jefferson Shreve, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Shreve for Congress.
The floodgates are about to open in Indiana as spring approaches. Do you know if your sump pump is working properly? During the month of March, my friends at Hope Plumbing are offering a free sump pump with the purchase of a battery backup. A sump pump is vital to protecting your home from heavy rains and rising waters that do nothing but leave behind damage in your home. Call Hope Plumbing today at 641-HOPE or visit them online at hopeplumbing.com for a free sump pump with the purchase of a battery backup.
Wealth-changing question. Has your advisor created a portfolio based only on your age and risk tolerance? That's simply not good enough. Your money deserves better, and so do you. At Creative Planning, our private wealth managers learn about you first, and then they create a customized plan and portfolio by partnering with our in-house money managers, accountants, and attorneys. Don't settle for a standard portfolio. Book your free meeting today at creativeplanning.com. Creative Planning, a richer way to wealth.
Why choose a Sleep Number smart bed?
Can it keep me warm when I'm cold?
Wait, no, I'm always hot.
Sleep Number does that. The Climate 360 smart bed actively cools or warms up to 13 degrees on either side for your ideal sleep temperature. 94% of Sleep Number smart sleepers report better sleep. J.D. Power ranks Sleep Number number one in customer satisfaction with mattresses purchased in-store. And now save $1,000 on our most popular Sleep Number smart bed and Saturday. For J.D. Power 2023 award information, visit jdpower.com/awards. To find a store near you, visit sleepnumber.com.
Hammer and Nigel presents
Is.
It depends upon what the meaning of the word is.
Is this anything?
All right, let's rock and roll.
Hammer, how do we play? Is this anything?
I'm going to run a few different stories by you. You are going to be the one that breaks down all the information and gives us a verdict. Is the story anything or not? We start with this. An overweight alligator was found living behind a former Coca-Cola plant that was ultimately captured, relocated, and now the fat alligator is on a diet to shed some of its 400 pounds.
Wow.
Here are some neighbors from where this big gator used to live.
All the kids know there's a gator there. Don't feed them. Don't mess with them. You know, I don't even allow them over here.
I just hope nobody don't, you know, jump the fence or it don't come out and somebody get attacked.
That's a little heavy for that animal. The trapper caught the alligator and brought him over. It really isn't far away, probably 3-4 miles away. All of our alligators get a mix of pelleted diet. There's a diet made by Missouri. That's the Purina company that's made just for alligators and crocodiles. We feed a lot of that. We also feed fish. We also feed chicken. So we'll do that on a regular basis. And hopefully with time, he'll slender down a little bit.
They're more concerned with this alligator and his diet than they are. Like, you know, there's somebody on Skid Row that doesn't have as good at have it as good as this alligator does.
Right.
I think it sucks that they, well, I guess they said they feed him like chicken and fish because I would assume alligators would eat anything. I mean, the scene in Roadhouse, did you watch Roadhouse? That was your assignment.
I have not seen the new one yet.
Great scene in Roadhouse involving an alligator. Great scene in Happy Gilmore involving an alligator. But 400 pounds, I wouldn't even think to, it wouldn't even occur to me that, boy, look at that alligator. It sure is getting fat.
Mike Gundy, your thoughts on the alligator?
If somebody makes fun of him or says he's fat.
You're right. We've got veterans that don't get treated as well as this big fat alligator. That's a shame. Is this anything? A dog in Florida playing in the yard was digging in the yard and found like an unexploded bomb. Here's the homeowner talking about his dog finding the old bomb.
Okay, is this live? You panic and then you drop it. You couldn't really tell what it was until you started to pull it up. And then once I got it like halfway out, I was like, oh, I know what this is. Let me just gently put this back down.
You know, my question would be, like, this is my backyard. Where is this, in Florida?
Yes.
What's a military, an unexploded military device doing in somebody's backyard?
You answered your own question. It's Florida. Florida man was probably having a hell of a fireworks display.
No, this is a military grade device. I'm looking at it right now. It's about a foot long, about 10 inches wide. And I'm just, how in the world would that ever wind up in somebody's backyard? It used to be a military installation where I live 50 years ago.
If I had access to it, I would have blown it up on the 4th of July. I'm just telling you that right now.
I don't think so.
You don't think I would have?
I think you probably would have blown up your entire block.
Do I care? It would have been the best 4th of July ever. I'm telling you that right now.
Would have been the final 4th of July ever.
Is this anything? A guy in Australia is in the doghouse after he left his fiance's $2,000 wedding dress on the roof of his car and then drove off. They're offering a $500 reward to anybody who can find it. Here's the bride.
Don't know why the dress was in the car. That wasn't me. As he moved the stuff to put the storage in the car, put the dress on top of the car to not crush it, and then proceeded to drive off. I guess I can replace the dress, but it's just more the frustration of the situation.
Well, you know how she feels. You left your wedding ring on her car, drove off.
I did.
And disappeared. By the way, her accent just reminds me of Shane Gillis' stand-up special on Netflix, Beautiful Dogs. There's that bit in there about how Australian accents will always be funny no matter what they're saying or what they're doing.
Right, right.
It was so highly inappropriate. I mean, that whole stand-up comedy special was just, didn't it make you kind of cringe, but you're laughing your ass off the entire time?
I loved it. I don't think my wife was laughing as hard as I was at times, but it was really good. Now, I admit I still have the assignment of watching the new Roadhouse that you gave me.
Yes.
I haven't got there yet.
Right, right, right.
I gave you the assignment of watching the Adam Sandler movie, That's My Boy. Have you seen that?
It just came on Netflix. It wasn't available to even purchase, I don't think, but it's on Netflix now. I have not watched it
yet. Okay, so there's a wedding dress scene in that movie, and that's all I'm going to say.
Okay.
All right, coming up next, this is what it's all about.
Come on now.
The finals of Meltdown Madness presented by Window Nation. This is the Hammer and Nigel Show.
You know, my wife and I were thinking about adding some additional space to our house, but also our sidewalk and front porch were falling apart, and I thought, yeah, maybe we need to take care of that first. So what do? We call the best there is in the business, Indeed Decorative Concrete. And trust me, I was completely blown away at what they could do in terms of taking a basic sidewalk and porch, and they turned it into a custom-stamped concrete area with more space and an absolutely awesome, unique look. I mean, the value I got when compared to doing a room addition is priceless. How much more entertaining and usable this space out front gave us a great summer last year when they did the installation, which only took 3 days, by the way. Everyone who works for Indy Decorative Concrete is a W-2 employee. No subcontractors coming to your house. In fact, our project manager was the owner's son-in-law. So whether it's a new patio, sidewalk, porch, whatever, don't do anything until you've checked out IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. And hurry, spring is right around the corner, and that's when they get swamped. So get in their books now to get your project done in the spring or summer. I love the job Indy Decorative Concrete did for me. You'll love them too. IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. Tell them Nigel sent you.
Business. It's not a 9-to-5 proposition. It's all day and into the night. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these businesses is a partner like Comcast Business helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup in the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide, all these businesses choose the advanced network, cybersecurity solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business. From Main Street to Wall Street, our people are powering the businesses that power it all. So when you're ready to unlock what's possible for your business, there's no one better to answer the call. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
Restrictions apply. Call or visit ComcastBusiness.com to learn more.
BoerRemodeling.com, serving Central Indiana for 23 years. These are your kitchen and bathroom remodeling specialists. When you're ready to make the change, they're ready for you. It's a new year, so it's time to get it done. That kitchen, that heart of the home, the bathroom, a place where you can actually relax and build instant equity in your home. 317-852-5546 or online at Boer, B-O-O-H-E-R, BoerRemodeling.com.
93 WIPC Mobile News, on the level, on the go.
If someone is at fault, he says they'll pay. Partly cloudy, 43 degrees in downtown Indianapolis, all clear on the radar. Low of 30 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 431. If someone was responsible for the Francis Scott Key Bridge collapse in Baltimore Tuesday, they'll be held accountable, promises Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg.
Any private party that is found responsible and liable will be held accountable.
Buttigieg says the U.S. Coast Guard and the Army Corps of Engineers are working to clean up to get the port back open where the bridge collapsed. While that port remains closed, it could disrupt supply chains, impacting local car dealerships.
We know that the automotive industry really got hit hard during COVID with the microchip shortage, and it's in some ways still coming out of that. So there's not a lot of inventory sitting around.
Purdue University supply chain management professor Amy David, she says local car dealers who sell American products will have a chance to increase their share with the markets. Your governor is making sure emergency response teams are ready for the April 8th solar eclipse. Donnie Burgess reports.
An executive order signed Wednesday by Governor Holcomb will allow Indiana to use emergency resources from other states. The goal is for Indiana to be as prepared as possible for any transportation or communication issues that could come up during the eclipse, as thousands of visitors are expected in the Hoosier State. This is all possible due to the partnerships provided by the Emergency Management Assistance Compact. Donnie Burgess, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
The average price you're paying for a gallon of gas in Indiana today is $3.47, according to GasBuddy.com. That's 6 cents below the national average. A great day on the market. The Dow finished up by 477 points to 39,760. The NASDAQ also up by 83 to 16,399. And the S&P 500 increasing as well by 44 points, finishing the day at 5,248. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 433.
Hi, my name is Paige Strodbeck, and I'm a member of Tabernacle Presbyterian Church.
TAB is a place where sound biblical teaching is the foundation for who we are and everything we do. Church at TAB isn't just for Sunday. It happens every day of the week through ministries that serve those inside and outside the church. From the pastor's Bible study to our chef-led cafe offering hot meals to organized youth sports, TAB is focused on living out the gospel of Jesus Christ. If you're looking for a church that combines faithful preaching with urban outreach, you've come to the right place. I'm Peg Strodbeck, and I invite you to come see for yourself.
Tabernacle Presbyterian Church, 34th Street and Central Avenue in Indianapolis, invites you to worship Sunday morning at 8 or 10 a.m. If you can't make it in person, tune in to Sunday with TAB, Sunday mornings at 6:30 on WIBC, or find us online at tabpres.org.
With traffic at 4:34, here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, crash clear. Southbound 465 east side after I-70. I know we're still stuck, like back past Penn Pike, 2 East 56, but the front of the line is starting to move a little bit better, so hopefully we'll get you out of there before too long. Northbound lanes in the same area. Stop and go from 70 up to Penn Pike, slow to 75th. Coming into downtown, southbound 65, stop and go 29th Meridian Pad. Eastbound 70, stop and go traffic from Belmont to the south, a split, and south side pockets are slow on eastbound 465 Kentucky Avenue past a 31. Traffic sponsored by Indy Decorative Concrete, Indy's leader in patio installation, is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Clouds begin to decrease later on today, so some sunshine, but it still stays cool. Highs near 48. Clear skies tonight. Areas of frost developing with lows near 32. I'm Wish TV Storm Tracking Meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show.
This is it. This is what all of those suicide sprints, all of those practices comes down to. The finals of Meltdown Madness presented by Window Nation.
Come on, baby.
Already punching his ticket to the championship game a couple days ago was Tommy Lasorda. Okay? So we had one more matchup to decide who was going to take on Tommy in today's final. It was between Casey Kasem, iconic broadcaster, famous for that Top 40 show, his meltdown and rant behind the scenes against the number one seed in this tournament, Bob Knight.
Sure.
Chewing out his players for a lack of effort, not recovering defensively. We've heard these clips a million times, and we're going to play one again here in just a moment. But to avoid the predictable pattern of what may happen, I'm going to do things a little differently here, Nige.
Okay.
I did this earlier on Kendall and Casey's show, and I think it bears repeating. Here to read their version of Casey Kasem's iconic meltdown is WIBC's Casey Daniels.
He was a little dog named Snuggles, but he was most certainly a part of Let's Go Start Again. See, when you come out of those up-tempo gotcha numbers, man, it's impossible to make those transitions. And then you got to go into somebody dying. You know, they do this to me all the time. I don't know what the hell they do it for, but goddamn it, if we can't come out of a slow record, I don't understand. Is Don on the phone? I want a goddamn concerted effort to come out of a record that isn't a fucking up-tempo record every time I do a goddamn death dedication. I want somebody to use his brain to not come out of a goddamn record that is that's up tempo, and I gotta talk about a fucking dog dying.
Oh, no. AI Casey reading, man. Casey Kasem.
I mean, that sounds like she went into one of these side production studios and read that herself. And you're telling me that's AI?
That's AI
that
Casey.
That is scary, and that is genius.
Now, here to read the rant from Robert Montgomery Knight is AI Robert Kendall.
If you're not going to recover Greg Graham, if you're just going to let him drive by you, if the rest of you are going to let him catch the ball outside the 3-second lane and drive all the way in here without one guy challenging him, then I'm leaving and you f***ing guys can run until you can't even suffer. Now, I'm tired of this shit. I'm sick and tired of a f***ing 8-10 record. I'm f***ing tired of losing to Purdue. I'm not here to f*** around this week. Now, you may be, but I'm not.
AI wow. Rob Kendall doing Bob Knight's
rant. How does that work? Is there like a function on that AI website where you can make them sound angry? You know what I mean? Because that Rob sounded angry during that.
I don't want to give away my secrets, but okay. There's a lot of trial and error. Right? Okay. You got to do some lines separately than others.
Oh, wow.
A lot of cutting and pasting goes into that.
Right.
I think we all knew how that was going to play out.
Yeah.
Bob Knight, 80% to 20, yeah, moves on to the finals. And now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is time for the finals of Meltdown Madness. And just like the old high school basketball days where you'd win a game in the morning and then you'd go back and play for the championship at night,
yep,
that's what Bob Knight's going to have to do here. So before we get going, here to read the official invocation is AI Joe Biden.
Hey, you know, we pray to Jesus, or as they say in France, Jesus. We hope everyone, you know, has a safe, safe birthday.
Sure.
We hope this matchup is almost as fun as sniffing hair of young children. So let's hurry up with this. I have to poop. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. What a just a touching prayer from the president.
And at this time, we ask those who are able to please rise and remove your hats. Here to perform our national anthem is the little girl from the Pacers game earlier this month.
Are you sure this isn't Fergie?
I saw this live.
Oh, yeah, you were there, weren't you?
Bring it home.
For the land of the free.
Yeah! Down, 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 down. Had to throw a little Steven Tyler in there.
I liked it. I liked it. And now for the moment that we've been waiting for. It's one of our favorite traditions. Here to perform Back Home Again in Indiana, Jim Cornelison.
When I dream about the moonlight on the Wabash, then I long for my Indiana home.
Ah, the pageantry.
There it is.
The heritage, the tradition that is Meltdown Madness on the Hammer and Nigel Show.
If the hair isn't standing up on your arm right now, oh, you're not even alive.
Trust me, I am.
Let's meet the starting lineups.
I love LA.
Coming in as the number 10 seed in this tournament, pulling off a big upset to beat Bill O'Reilly along the way. Iconic Los Angeles Dodgers manager, Tommy Lasorda, very upset that anybody would think that he would order one of his pitchers to throw at members of the San Diego Padres, including utility infielder Kurt Bavacqua.
I have never, ever, since I've managed, ever told a pitcher to throw at anybody, nor will I ever. And if I ever did, I certainly wouldn't make him throw at a 130 hitter like a fucking Bavakwa who couldn't hit water if he fell out of a fucking boat. And I guarantee you this, when I pitched and I was going to pitch against a team that had guys on it like Bavakwa, I sent a limousine to get the to make sure he was in the motherfucking lineup.
Wow. That's strong. That's going to be tough to beat.
I don't know.
And now for the number one seed in our tournament. To set the mood, Martha the Mop Lady. If you grew up in Indiana and you watch Channel 4, you know exactly what this is.
Starting to tear up a little bit at the nostalgia.
Come on, clap your hands. Come on. The number one seed. The head coach of the Indiana Hoosiers, Robert Montgomery Knight, in a secretly recorded rant inside of the locker room, very upset that certain members of his team, like Greg Graham, were not giving their all for the cream and crimson.
I mean, if you're not going to recover Greg Graham, if you're just going to let him drive by you, if the rest of you are going to let him catch the ball outside the three-second lane and drive all the way in here without one guy challenging him, then I'm leaving and you freaking guys will run till you can't even suffer. Now, I'm tired of this shit. I'm sick and freaking tired of an 8-10 record. I'm freaking tired of losing to Purdue. I'm not here to freak around this week. Now, you may be, but I'm not.
There's your winner right there. I'm sorry. I mean, you know, Tommy Lasorda's had a good run.
It's been backed by the Kendall and Casey show. It's been endorsed by the Kendall and Casey show.
Who? Do we know who recorded that locker room rant? Has there been any theory?
I'm sure there is, but I don't know. I'll have to text our pal, the coach. Maybe he knows.
I'm sure we've asked before because we had Greg Graham on the show. We had the coach on the show plenty of times and talked about that.
But they weren't even fazed by it.
Not at all. It was just like, I think Greg Graham said, just another Tuesday.
Right. I've heard way worse. Now, producer Allison, go ahead.
There's an internet conspiracy theory that the then student manager, Lawrence Frank, a former NBA coach,
yes,
and president of the basketball operations of the Clippers, he was the one.
Lawrence Frank.
I remember that. I know that name.
Yeah, was the coach of the Nets for a little while.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's out there. Not confirmed, but that's out there.
Curious.
But you know what else is out there? The finals. The poll is live. It's pinned to our Twitter, at Hammer and Nigel. If you don't have a Twitter or an X account, create one just to vote. Make sure you follow us. It's pinned to the top. Which of those meltdowns do you want to be crowned the champion of this year's Meltdown Madness presented by Window Nation? Tommy Lasorda ranting against Kurt Bavakwa or Bob Knight ripping his team at halftime? Now, you need to understand, Kendall and Casey are really going to push.
Oh, I know.
For Tommy Lasorda, yeah, during their show tomorrow. So make sure you get your votes in right
now. I don't
now
think it's going to matter.
At Hammer and Nigel, Meltdown Madness.
It is almost spring cleaning time at Window Nation. Look, if your windows are cracked, leaking, they won't open or stay open, now is the time to call Window Nation, especially with this deal. Buy two windows, get two free, plus zero down, zero interest, and zero payments for 24 months. Listen to what Window Nation customer Samantha had to say. Very professional and polite. I did not feel pressured about anything. They couldn't have been any better. Thank you, Samantha. That was my exact same experience with Window Nation.
If you've been thinking about getting new windows, do yourself a favor and call Window Nation, 866-90-NATION. They'll explain everything to you. They will give you all of the deals, all of the promotions. And the biggest deal they have is buy two windows, get two for free, and you don't pay anything. No interest for two full years. 866-90-NATION. Call today, talk to a representative, or go to windownation.com. Tell them Hammer and Nigel sent you.
Your new car, your new truck, your new electric vehicle is at Andy Moore Ford in Plainfield because they've got the deal that can't be beat. All of the new cars and trucks you're looking for and electric vehicles like the all-electric F-150 Lightning with seating up to 5, intelligent backup power, and on-site power for all your tools and gear. This all-electric truck is built for it all. Andy Moore Ford also has the rebates for you. Federal and state incentives. You could save more on your EV purchase up to $7,500 instantly on site and save more on all of their cars and trucks, their fleet vehicles, and their electric vehicles. Andy Moore Ford in Plainfield, including more to your door. You can just buy the car online and they will deliver it directly to you. Andy Moore Ford, visit them on Main Street in Plainfield or online at andymooreford.com. That's Andy Moore, M-O-H-R. I love Andy. andymooreford.com.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Do you need air conditioning service and need to find a local well-trained expert you can trust, like Family Heating and Air Conditioning? Find that American Standard Air dealer at IndyHomeComfort.com.
Everyone knows that soaking in Epsom salts can make you feel better. Now imagine soaking in Epsom salts in a Royal Spa hot tub.
Royal Spa.
Addiction. It's hard on those who struggle with it, but those who love the addict need support too. Matt Baer and Ryan Hedrick provide help and hope with Supporting Sobriety. Subscribe wherever you get your podcasts and on WIPC.com.
All right, Matt Baer, the finals have been set. It's Tommy Lasorda, it's Bob Knight, it's Meltdown Madness. It's your last vote. Where's it going?
Goes with the underdog, Tommy Lasorda.
Oh, and, wow.
Yeah, we got to pull for the underdog, but man. Looking at southbound 465 east side, stop and go east 56 past 70. That crash is cleared. Northbound lane, stop and go right now 70 past Penn Pike. Southbound 65, stop and go from 29th to Meridian Penn and dragging big time on eastbound 72 downtown from Belmont to the south split. Traffic sponsored by Indy Decorative Concrete. Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
The poll on Twitter literally just went live a couple minutes ago.
Yeah.
Already 137 votes have come in.
Wow.
Bob Knight has an early lead. So get those votes coming in. Don't wait. Don't forget, you've got less than 20 hours to vote. Nige will have the big winner tomorrow and the ceremonial One Shining Moment montage at the end. But you got to vote now at Hammer and Nigel on Twitter. 44 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center, 93 WIBC.
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Everything you need to know about that debate last night, GOP Republican governor's debate here for in Indiana, we'll have that after 5 o'clock with Dr. Laura, who is the political science professor there, U of I. Is your kid taking classes, or Dr. Laura Wilson's classes yet?
Yeah. He hasn't had her as a professor yet. I think he's got her on the schedule for next year.
Gotcha. Okay, so she's going to break it all down for us after 5 o'clock. Remember that scene in Star Wars, Hammer, where the first Star Wars, I mean, you know, A New Hope, when
right.
It came out in 19...
I don't want all the nerds going, technically that was the... No. The first one released.
The scene where Luke is having breakfast with Uncle Owen and Aunt Beru. And he's drinking the blue milk. By the way, Aunt Beru, sweet lady. Uncle Owen, bit of a prick.
Yeah.
Anyway, he's drinking that blue milk. A Star Wars brand blue milk is hitting the stores in April.
So in April, I can drink the same milk that the people that shielded yes. Luke.
This is an anticipation and a celebration of the Star Wars Day on May the 4th, you know, May the 4th be with you.
Right.
Mike Tyson would say it that way, probably.
May the 4th.
So blue milk, so you're going to be able to buy blue milk. And here is our quick, lame tribute to that.
Blue milk, you can drink blue milk, you can drink blue milk, it's almost here.
That's it. That's all I got.
That's all we got?
That's it. That's all we have. Are you going out of your way to buy blue milk?
No. I wasn't going to until I heard that amazing jingle you put together, yeah. And now I might buy two bottles.
Not exactly AI Biden, was it?
Kind of had the Bill Murray feel to it right there.
Star Wars, nothing but Star Wars.
Dateline, the UK. All this guy in England had to do at his wedding was repeat these words. I will laugh with you when you are happy, comfort you when you are sad.
Okay.
That's all he had to say. But instead, he said this to his beautiful bride.
I will care for you.
I will care for you.
Laugh with you when you are happy. Comfort you when you are sad.
Laugh with you when you're sad.
No, comfort you when you're sad.
I'll laugh at you when you're sad.
Did you make up your own vows at your wedding? We never did.
No, we just went along with it.
Yeah, we just read what our officiant was the basic traditional thing. We did not break out. I did not break out a piece of paper and start reading it to Lindsay as I was up there.
Now, yeah, I'm sure were the same way. Like whatever the officiant said, do you take her to be? You know, I do that kind of stuff. But I've seen again from being a wedding DJ some of those moments. They go on forever. Like, people need to understand, you don't have to speak for 15 minutes just because you're the center of attention.
Right.
Whether it's the bride and the groom or bridesmaid or best man. And I'm sorry, ladies, but it's bridesmaids who are the worst at this. Because the bridesmaid, she's the one that feels like all eyes are on her. It's not about you. It's about the bride. So you got to understand, to quote The Rock, know your role and shut your mouth. But if we're going to have some fun with this, let's do it. Great moments in wedding history. This is when a groom had very cringy vows that he wrote for his lovely bride.
Only two things are required to keep me happy. Keep my belly full and my balls empty. So you're amazing at half of it. We really need to get you some cooking lessons. Even when my belly isn't full, there is no one I could ever love more in this lifetime, unless I actually get a chance to meet Margot Robbie. Since the beginning, I was always told, life gets even better when the kids fall asleep and you tell me to come to the bedroom. Nothing's better than the sound of gagging and headboard slamming.
Michael.
P.S., since you're so good at making decisions like Mary and me, you can choose whether tonight's going to end with being a toaster strudel or a Twinkie.
Alrighty.
This is real.
Being that I am his mom, I will deal with him later. He is grounded, by all means.
That's real.
That's not a joke. That was from a real wedding ceremony.
Great moments in wedding vow history. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Now is the perfect time for you to call the Bath Authority to get your project you've been putting off done this spring. Because the Bath Authority has an unbelievable deal going on. Call today at 317-532-5711. 317-532-5711. Schedule your free in-home estimate and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. That's right. All you got to do is call today at 317-532-5711. Schedule a free in-home estimate with the Bath Authority and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath plus 36 months of interest-free financing. Walk-in tubs, replacement showers, tub-to-shower conversions, and more. The Bath Authority does it all. 317-532-5711 for $1,000 off a new shower or bath plus 36 months of interest-free financing. TheBathAuthority.com. Tell them Rob sent you.
Are you over 30 and putting off life insurance? It's time to get a quick quote from Ethos, a better, easier way to get term life insurance. All online with no medical exam. Answer a few health questions and you could be approved for up to $2 million. Isn't it worth 10 minutes to help protect your family's financial security? Ethos, up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as a dollar a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at checkethos.com. That's checkethos.com.
It's the Early Bird Garden Special this week at Miss M's Home and Garden. 20% off seeds and 50% off Easter decor. State Road 135 in Bargersville. Closed Easter.
Dance happen.
There's a whole lot of stuff that can mess up the look of your vehicle. Don't paint your car. Go PDR with Killa Dent Removal. PDR is paintless dent removal that saves your factory finish and is way less invasive than traditional body shop repairs. And it's faster, too, sometimes same day. Google Killa Dent Removal and check out the reviews and photos. Then schedule your repair. Hail, baseballs, kids, fender benders, shopping carts, flying cows, angry exes, and anything else that leaves dents. Don't paint your car. Go PDR with Killa Dent Removal.
I'm Deidre Hall with a message about your eye health. My mother had age-related macular degeneration, or AMD, which means my family members are at greater risk. AMD affects vision, and having low vision as a result of wet AMD, the more severe form of AMD, can mean a task like driving can become a major challenge.
I'm Dr. Sada of the Doheny Eye Institute in UCLA. AMD is the most common cause of severe, irreversible vision loss in older adults in the U.S. AMD affects central vision, which lets you see fine details. About 9 million Americans are living with wet AMD or are at risk. If you're over 50, smoke, or have a family history of wet AMD, you could be at increased risk. If a healthcare professional suspects wet AMD, a retina specialist can confirm the diagnosis and work with you on a treatment plan.
Routine eye care, including regular eye exams, can help maintain your vision. Visit www.geteyesmart.org for more information.
Tune in Saturdays 9 to 1 for the Home and Garden Show for advice and fun. Brought to you by Michaelis. Water, storms, fire, and wet basements. Life happens. Michaelis happens to help you through it.
Coming up in 2 minutes, a child's been shot on the northeast side of Indy. They're in stable condition. Why Governor Eric Holcomb is concerned about safety during the solar eclipse next month, and how Plainfield police are getting the most out of a new canine officer. All that and more coming up after Fox News Radio from the Technology Recycler Studios. You're listening to 93 WIBC, WIBC HD1 Indianapolis. It's 5 o'clock.
A long and difficult path. Elisa Brady, Fox News, was described for Baltimore, where a vital port is closed until further notice after yesterday's collapse of the Key Bridge, a portion of it still resting on the cargo ship that hit a support column.
We still don't fully know the condition of the portions of the bridge that are still standing or of infrastructure that is below the surface of the water. So rebuilding will not be quick or easy or cheap, but we will get it done.
Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg says there's no timeline yet for moving the ship and reopening the port, but that he would expect that could happen much more quickly than bridge reconstruction. Maryland Governor Wes Moore says the port closure will have a wide-ranging economic impact.
The Port of Baltimore is responsible for cars, heavy vehicles, agricultural equipment, the largest amount in the entire country. So this is not just going to impact Maryland. This is impacting the farmer in Kentucky. It's impacting the auto dealer in Michigan.
Fox Business's Hillary Vaughn.
The other big economic question is, could this impact inflation with supply chain hiccups as goods are being rerouted to other ports? But Secretary Buttigieg says today he doesn't expect this to have a huge impact on inflation. He thinks that the supply chain issues here are more specialized and localized than what we saw during the pandemic. So they don't expect this to impact inflation broadly nationwide.
As the NTSB investigates, the Coast Guard says the ship operator has activated its salvage and pollution plans. Divers continue the search for the bodies of six missing construction workers. The U.S. will keep pushing for a ceasefire and hostage deal between Israel and Hamas.
We do think it's possible to bridge those differences, and we're going to continue to try to bridge those differences.
State Department spokesman Matthew Miller, as the Israeli prime minister, says he hopes Hamas got the message that international pressure won't work. Though Israel's also working to reschedule a canceled trip for talks in Washington on the Israeli military plans for the city of Rafah in Gaza. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
A child shot. Mostly sunny at the Circle at 44 degrees. All good at the radar. Low of 30 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 5:02. Indy Metro Police say a child was shot on the northeast side of Indianapolis this afternoon. It happened at the Villages at Mill Crossing apartment complex on Blue Spruce Lane near 38th and North Sherman Drive. The child is in stable condition. Police are still investigating. Purdue business professor Amy David predicts supply chain shortages as Baltimore's ports closes. She says car imports from Europe and the Middle East will be delayed, but
it may actually be an opportunity for some of the car makers that are in the Midwest or locally to gain a little bit of market share.
David says with fewer European cars available, Indiana-based car dealerships could attract customers who would typically opt for European brands. Your safety is a top priority for the state during the April 8th solar eclipse.
I'm Donnie Burgess. Governor Holcomb signed an executive order Wednesday allowing Indiana to tap into the emergency resources of other states during the solar eclipse. Thousands of visitors are expected in Indiana, which is why the governor is working ahead of time to make sure state responders are ready in case there's a major emergency. Donnie Burgess, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
Three people accused of stealing nearly 600 cans of baby formula from a Walmart in Boonville were arrested. Edgar Ramirez, Nora Zarate, and a juvenile were all put in handcuffs last Thursday after Boonville police found the formula in the car they were driving. Altogether, that formula was worth more than $22,000. Helping children and fighting crime. Those are two things that the Plainfield Police Department says a new canine is doing for them. John Herrick reports.
That police canine's name is Newt. She's a boxer mix who nearly died because her former owner was cruel to her. After she was rescued, an officer thought she had the ability to become both a therapy dog as well as a dog who could be used to spot guns on criminals who are not allowed to have them. Now that she and her canine handler, Josh Jellison, have gone through the necessary training, they have become certified. The Plainfield Police Department calls Newt's story one of resiliency, triumph, and compassion. John Herrick, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
Traffic and weather in 60 seconds. It's 5:04.
I've been asked 1,000 times, did you plan on becoming the largest injury law firm in the world? And the answer is no. When I started, there were just two of us. Today, Morgan & Morgan has almost 800 lawyers alone. No injury firm in the country has anywhere close to that. We set out to be focused on our clients and to have a commitment to trying cases and winning. And when you have those results at trial, you're able to settle most of your cases quickly and fairly. Reputation matters. We grew like this because we worked hard and so many former clients referred family and friends. And what I believe is the main reason is we deliver for our clients a lot. Hard work and client satisfaction was our plan. It worked. Hope is not a plan. Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm. Visit forthepeople.com for an office near you.
With traffic on the 5s at 5:05, here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, looking at the east side, northbound 465, slow from 70 up to Penn Pike. Southbound lanes dragging a little bit from a earlier crash, just as southbound 465 after 70. It's gone. Southbound 65, two downtown, stop and go, MLK to Meridian Penn. Eastbound 70, stop and go to downtown. That's Holt Road to Meridian, Illinois. Eastbound 465 on the south side slows Kentucky past the White River. Westbound lane stop and go from 31 over to Harding. And northbound 37 stops Epler to 465. Traffic sponsored by InvisibleFence.com. Don't get stuck gearing up for spring while everyone else is enjoying the warm weather. Invisible Fence brand works in any season, giving your vet the freedom they deserve now. Visit InvisibleFence.com to learn more. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Clouds begin to decrease later on today, so some sunshine, but it still stays cool. Highs near 48. Clear skies tonight. Areas of frost developing with lows near 32. I'm Wish TV Storm Tracking Meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the level on the go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Can you believe these characters are weirdos?
So let's rock it!
Nigel, Jason Hammer right over there with a special guest on the WIBC hotline.
Dr. Laura Wilson is a professor of political science at the University of Indianapolis. She joins us. Doctor, you have been the moderator for a couple different debates. What did you think of the job done by CBS4 last night, the moderators with that gubernatorial debate?
Well, you know, I have to say I'm a little biased because I've worked with them, and I do know them on a personal level, but I thought they did a great job. It is always hard to moderate, and I've never moderated a debate where we had more than three candidates, and anytime you add one more candidate, right, it's one more a variable in the dynamic. It's one more person you have to add in terms of rebuttals and things like that. I thought they were very effective at going through a large range of issues. Some of them felt a little odd. I know there were some that probably people were wondering why they talked about, but capturing a large range of issues in 60 minutes to give you a good sense of at least 2/3 of the field for the Republican primary, since, of course, Rettenauer and Hill didn't qualify and weren't able to be on the stage.
And our pals at Wish TV, they get their opportunity tonight. They've got their turn for a debate. So I'm going to look at it a different way. You are somebody that's moderated debates. I'm somebody that has put together events. I wasn't happy with the way that it was structured last night. I get you want to get as many topics in an hour. I understand that. But some topics I think are more important than others. Like talking about the time zone should not have the same time limit as talking about taxes in Indiana. Does that make sense?
It absolutely makes sense, and I laugh when you say that because I think most people probably share your opinion. And the counter argument I thought was interesting about that particular question, right? It's not innately political. We knew if you had a bingo card, you knew IDEC was going to come up. You knew you were going to hear questions about gasoline tax. You probably suspected something with abortion, maybe with IVF and Alabama state Supreme Court decision would come up too, right? The thing I liked about that question was that I do think it's something people periodically complain about, right? Every time we set our clocks forward or backward.
Yeah.
And it's not your average person who doesn't even pay attention to politics. They probably have an opinion about daylight savings time otherwise. I would say where it was put in the debate, being at 7:32, I think is when it came up, so it's nearly halfway through, is your average person who's not paying attention to politics paying attention at that point? Maybe not. But I will say organizing and figuring out like what are the priorities is always going to be challenging because most people don't watch all the debate. So you may just capture their attention until this didn't have commercial breaks, which helps. But, like the first few questions and someone's like, oh, I'm kind of bored. Let's go look at something else. I think it's not just the order, of course. It's like what do you include? And inevitably, you can't include it all. You get 60 minutes. You have 1 hour. What they choose to add and to take out, I think, is really difficult.
Dr. Laura, is it important for a debate and or candidate to be somewhat entertaining, and maybe entertaining is the wrong word, but like, Vivek Ramaswamy was a very dynamic, great orator. And I'm not sure that I saw a lot of that on stage. How important is that aspect of being
charismatic?
Charismatic, very good word. Charismatic, yeah.
I think it's incredibly important, but there is a slight caveat to it. So to the argument that it's important, people naturally like watching people that are charismatic, even if you quite frankly disagree on several issues.
Sure.
You still can't take your eyes off or you're like, wow, they're just so articulate. They're speaking to me. They're very personable. And I think in that regard, it can really help a candidate, especially with voters who maybe don't care as much about the policies. They may not know about the policies. There's that old adage in campaigning, right? Somebody you want to have a beer with. And there is a lot of value to that alone. The thing in this particular race, if you're looking, this is a crowded primary. You have six candidates. I don't know that any of them are necessarily overwhelmingly charismatic. In fact, many of them might be characterized as bland, and that's not a judgment call. It's just,
No one's I agree.
Super outgoing, right? The benefit is that no one's super outgoing, right? You're not competing. And if one of them was very charismatic, the other five would look very dour. But at least you're on an equal playing field. If anything, for voters, that means you do have to pay attention. You have to make a judgment call, not just based on who you want to have a beer with, because you might not know, but who really aligns with what you're interested in? Who has a vision that you agree with? Like, who do you think has the most experience or expertise or the value that you want to see added into that office? And so in a way, for this particular race,
price, I feel like you're taking it out as a variable because it's the same across the board.
Right.
And in that regard, I don't know that it matters as much as it would in most other circumstances.
So, Doctor, we play a game on our show sometime called Am I a Horrible Person? Where listeners basically judge the bejesus out of me. Am I a horrible person? Because when I hear somebody say, he looks like someone I would want to have a beer with, I mock that person. I laugh at that person because you're never going to have a beer with the president or the governor or the senator. Like, less than 1% will have a beer with those people.
And plus, basing your opinion purely on that, and not policy also doesn't really make sense to me.
I think you are a realistic person. Like, if that was the game, yes. I don't think it's horrible at all. And I think the trick is that charisma matters in the absence of policy. And that is exactly the problem is, well, if you don't know anything else, who's the person that resonates? I love charismatic people. I'm drawn to people with interesting backstories, right? Like, I think that's human nature. We all are to different degrees. But if I know someone, I know what they stand for, I know what they do, and I don't like it, there's no amount of sparkle, as I like to say, right? There's nothing in terms of how they speak to me or the stories they can tell, the narratives they provide. Like, they would be fun to get drunk with, maybe, but it's not going to be the person I vote for. It's an absence of policy where that matters. And in some ways, it's like you could get into the, is this dangerous for democracy because people are making decisions about beer drinking and not actual voting on policy? And then in that case, again, I'd say that is a concern.
And a little reminder, coming up in our show, it is Beer Sample Wednesday this week. Dr. Laura Wilson, professor of political science, joining us. Were you surprised at all that some of the folks that are not polling at the top, right? Crouch, Doden, those two specifically, every poll that I've seen has got Braun at the top, Chambers close. Those two did not go after any of the front runners last night. If they did, it was very minimal. I did not see any fire. They didn't go after the people that are polling better than them. Was that a surprise to you?
It was a surprise. I think there were a couple missed opportunities, in particular Braun missing a big vote. None of the other candidates went against him. There was a moment where Doden and Crouch kind of sparred, but they were also towards the bottom of polling, so you know, you wonder how effective that necessarily is. I think for me, it's always this paradox of, like, for the entertainment value, I like to see the arguments. And it's not just because it is entertaining, right? But it's getting at the heart of the issue. It's like, no, you know, in your ad, you say this, but in fact, you did that. And look, this candidate's claiming this right now, but we know X, Y, Z. Like, it's actually holding them accountable. And I think that is really important. There's an aspect of that that I think is valuable in campaigns. And when you're looking at a debate, if you don't have that, you're missing out. At the same time, I would say I appreciate, and maybe it's just, you know, Hoosier hospitality. Maybe it's because they're Indiana candidates and maybe they're just all nice enough people. But it didn't get to that border of, like, being so uncivil or disrespectful in any way. I think it was a very civil and respectful debate that people start to say, oh, politics, it's so dirty. Oh, all the politicians are so bad. And I hear that all the time from people. If you looked at that debate this evening or yesterday evening, and if you look at the one tonight, what I think will be predictably the same, these candidates have a level of respect for each other, right? There is civility in politics, and I think this proves it, and each individual candidate has that as part of their character. Now, I would hope to see a little bit more challenge to their opponents, right? Like calling them out on things, because that's what you're able to do, and that's the opportunity you get to do on the debate stage. But on the flip side, and we have seen, I know you all have seen them, right? The presidential debates where you're laughing, you're crying, you're cringing, and then you're like, wait a second, these are going to be the next, one of these guys is the next leader of our country. Like, I didn't get that feeling watching this debate.
And finally, with the debates, Doctor, not so much the debates, but I mean, let's be honest with everybody. It's money, right? It's money that's going to get someone to the top of the heap of this race. It's how much money you spend, and Braun is that guy, it seems like, so far.
Yeah, he absolutely is. Money matters and name recognition matters, and they're mutually reinforcing, right? So Braun has served in the Senate for 6 years. He obviously has a lot of money of his own, but I think he has that name recognition and power that donors recognize. And Chambers has that, and Crouch has that to a lesser degree, too. I think you also see at this point, since we're at the end of March, there is that aspect of critical mass. Like, people want to support a winner. And so right now they're gauging their bets, like, who's most likely to get this seat? And that's the person you want to support. And you start to see that happening, especially as we're getting close to early voting and we're almost a month away from the election. Money absolutely matters. It's not the end all be all. You could be the best funded candidate and lose, but it's a little bit harder in that case.
Doctor, as a product of the University of Alabama, how does it feel knowing that without Nick Saban, you're going to lose to Tennessee every single year moving forward?
Oh, my goodness. Well, I was hoping you'd just say, like, how did I feel when the announcement happened? And I'll tell you, I cried. I cried for the loss of Nick Saban, but I'm hopeful we'll come back very strong that third week of October. It's I Hate Orange Week in Alabama.
Dr. Laura Wilson, Professor of Political Science at the University of Indianapolis. Doctor, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Matt Baer has a look at the roads.
All right, Hammer, on the north side, it is a crash eastbound at 465 near Allisonville Road. It's on the right shoulder, causing stop-and-go traffic back to Westfield Boulevard. Also a crash on the east side. This is 30th of Post. Coming into downtown, southbound 65, stop-and-go MLK to Meridian Ped. And then that delay continues if you're going southbound 6570 from Fletcher Avenue down to the south split. Eastbound 70, stop-and-go before Belmont into the south split. You turn north and you'll be slow to the Washington Street exit. Also northbound 65 heading towards the northwest side from downtown, stop and go from the north split up to 21st Street. Traffic sponsored by Mr. Quick Home Services, now hiring. Mr. Quick is offering a paid apprenticeship to become a heating and AC technician, $17 an hour, while learning a trade with six-figure earning potential. Class starts April 15th. Register at jobs.com. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
Man, looking at the polling for Meltdown Madness,
what's it looking like?
We could be on pace for a record voter turnout here, but right now, Bob Knight has a 69.4 to 30.6% lead over Tommy Lasorda. Get your votes in now. Every vote counts. Meltdown Madness pinned to the top of our Twitter. Right now, we got sunshine, temperature around 45 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center, and we'll play a round of Are You Okay With This? Next.
Jefferson Shreve stepped up to fight when no one else would. He put it all on the line, and the liberals smeared him for it with ads like this.
Donald Trump and Jefferson Shreve. He's an original supporter of Donald Trump.
They attacked Shreve for being a conservative.
Jefferson Shreve, an A rating from the NRA.
Attacked him for being a loyal Republican.
Look who was there, Jefferson Shreve. He was proud to be on the Trump campaign and proud of his own A rating from the NRA.
All because Shreve would get tough, back the blue, and stop the crime. But we don't have to accept their lawlessness at our border, in our suburbs, in our state. Because Jefferson Shreve is running for Congress, and he's a fighter for law, order, and a secure border. Jefferson Shreve for Congress.
I'm Jefferson Shreve, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Shreve for Congress.
Tony Katz here for Premier Arms in Brownsburg. This is your premier gun store. Premier Arms has the experience and know-how to help the new gun buyer and the most experienced marksman. They've been in business for over 20 years and have a friendly, knowledgeable staff that wants to help you, not talk down to you. Premier Arms in Brownsburg is family-friendly, so bring the kids. All ages are welcome. Everyone can find what they're looking for at Premier Arms in Brownsburg, 3754 South Green Street, online at premierarms.com. Tell them Tony Katz sent you, premierarms.com.
You expect your home to protect everything you love, but you don't expect the ways water is breaking down your basement and damaging your home. Mold, cracks, and of course visible water are just a few signs your basement is compromised. But there's one way to get answers to all your concerns. A free home inspection from Indiana Foundation Service. We put water back in its place. Get your free inspection at indianafoundation.com.
Everyone wants energy that's reliable and affordable. I've been a Duke Energy line worker here in Indiana for almost 20 years. So I'm proud to help deliver that for the people and the communities that matter most to me. With stronger, more resilient systems, better able to stand up to severe weather, and support for local businesses and jobs. It feels good knowing I'm helping build a smarter energy future for all of us.
Paid for by Duke Energy shareholders.
Life insurance. Why are you putting it off? Can't afford it? Too much hassle? Think you don't need it? There's lots of excuses for putting off life insurance. But if you weren't there, who would pay the mortgage and other bills? With Ethos, you could be covered in 10 minutes and boom, family protected. Ethos, fast and easy online term life insurance. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as a dollar a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at getethos.com. That's getethos.com.
Inside Indiana Business Radio, the news you need to get ahead. Indiana's business news leader, weekdays at 6:32 a.m. and 5:56 p.m. on WIBC.
Everyone knows that soaking in Epsom salts can make you feel better. Now imagine soaking in Epsom salts in a Royal Spa hot tub.
Ah, Royal Spa.
Are you really okay with this?
Are you okay?
Everything's gonna be okay.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I'm pretty f***ing far from okay.
Are you okay with this? On the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Oh, yeah!
Hammer headline on TMZ.
Okay.
Rebel Wilson claims Sacha Baron Cohen asked her to stick finger up his buttocks.
That's an actual headline.
Oh, that is the headline.
Wow.
You know who Rebel Wilson is. Right.
She's probably best known for being Fat Amy on the Pitch Perfect movies. But
she's a comedic actress.
Right.
And she's lost a lot of weight. And so she's got this new book coming out called Rebel Rising. And so People Magazine got an excerpt and she is describing things that happened on the set of the Sacha Baron Cohen movie, The Brothers Grimsby. Did you ever see that?
I did not.
Including a lot of inappropriate behavior a la the headline that I just referred to you to. Are you okay with this?
So is it a cop-out answer if I say I want more information? Because what I've learned about these types of things, whether it's Trevor Bauer, whether it's the Duke lacrosse kids, that whole line of believe all women all the time, it's a load of crap. Because there are some gold diggers, there are some skeezers. Now, maybe something did happen. I don't know. And that's why I'm asking permission from the panel here. Is it a cop-out if I say I don't want to jump to conclusions and I want more information?
Here's the thing. He wasn't asking her, from what I understand, to do it like in his dressing room. He was asking her to do a lot of inappropriate, crazy crap on the screen for the sake of the movie.
Like impromptu kind of things.
Yeah, like in Borat, when he's wrestling around with that fat dude that he travels around with, and they're wrestling naked, and
right.
He's got this, his beanbag in his face and stuff like that. That's my understanding of this situation.
So this wasn't a Weinstein casting couch type of situation.
No.
See, this is why it's important that everybody waits before you rush to judge, because you never know what a headline might mean or even if it's true or not.
Can I just say that the Brothers Grimsby, I don't know if it's worth your time or not, but it's probably not. It's like the worst of the Sacha Baron Cohen movies, but it has one of the funniest scenes involving Rebel Wilson I've ever seen in a movie. So their boyfriend and girlfriend or husband. Brothers Grimsby is about like this top spy, this top, he's like an assassin. But Sacha Baron Cohen is his stupid doofus, know-nothing hooligan brother.
Okay.
And they have to team up for an assignment. So you got a serious assassin with his idiot. It's a funny premise. So Rebel Wilson is his girlfriend or husband or wife, I'm sorry. And she's on a leather couch. She's sitting in a skirt, and she's all horned up, right? And she's pretending like it's a Sharon Stone type of moment in Basic Instinct.
And this is back when she was still a bigger gal.
Really? Yeah. And so you know what happens when you sit on a leather couch. It makes all sorts of noises, when especially on skin on skin. And she kind of ever slightly, spreads her. Here, I'll just play the clip for you. Here you go.
Look. I'm exactly like Sharon Stallone in Basic Instincts. Don't worry, that didn't come out my bum.
Oh.
But that one did.
So she's trying to be sexy on this leather couch. Sounds are happening. Some of it's the couch, some of it's not the couch.
I think at one point, Sacha Baron Cohen's character ends up in totally inside the orifice of an elephant, if I'm not mistaken.
Well, it's pretty much on par for his types of films, right?
Right. Krispy Kreme donuts are coming to McDonald's, Hammer. Oh, my goodness. Three types of Krispy Kreme donuts, glazed, chocolate, and chocolate ice cream filled, go on sale at McDonald's restaurants starting later this year. The company has announced this revelation. Are you okay with this?
So you're asking me if I'm okay with the fact that I can go through the drive-thru, get a Big Mac, McNuggets, and a Krispy Kreme donut with cream filling inside?
Yes.
Yes, I'm okay with this. This is the best day of my life. Like, would you look at the great days that have happened in the history of this country? July 4th, 1776.
Sure.
Bunch of other stuff, and now, now, Krispy Kreme partnering with McDonald's. This is amazing. This is the best. And if you weren't a big fat bastard already, I bet my bottom dollar you're going to become one. Because again, when Big Macs and Krispy Kreme high five, you can feel the electricity running through your vein. You can feel the calories moving to your ass. Okay. This is amazing. I'm here for it. Yes, this is something.
Real quick, the online gambling site BetUS is hiring a, quote, wiener concierge to travel around to different major league ballparks and measure their hot dogs. They want the length, girth, and weight for each one. Are you okay with this?
I believe it's a wiener connoisseur.
What'd I say?
Concierge. Concierge, somebody that works at the hotel.
Yeah, wiener. Okay, wiener. God, boy, I messed that one up, didn't I?
Good God. Harrison Silcox is standing by.
Well, no, are you okay with the wiener connoisseur?
Say it again.
Connoisseur. There, I got it. Are you okay with the wiener connoisseur? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
You're okay with it.
Sure. If they're going to pay you to eat the wieners, you can be the connoisseur of the wieners.
Yeah, I got that one wrong.
Got a little Beach Grove enlisting going on in here this afternoon. All right. Tony Kennett of the Tony Kennett cast. He's coming up next. And now my favorite connoisseur of the news is Harrison Silcox.
93 WIPC Mobile News, on the level, on the go.
It could impact car sales. 45 degrees, mostly clear skies downtown. You got a clear radar at a low of 30 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 529. Purdue business professor Amy David predicts supply chain shortages as Baltimore's port closes. She says car imports from Europe and the Middle East will be delayed, but
it may actually be an opportunity for some of the car makers that are in the Midwest or locally to gain a little bit of market share.
David says with fewer European cars available, some dealerships in Indiana could get some more customers who might now buy American. Indy Metro Police say a child was shot on the northeast side this afternoon. It happened at the Villages at Mill Crossing apartment complex on Blue Spruce Lane near 38th and North Sherman Drive. The child reported in stable condition. Police are still looking into the shooting. The Biden administration is working to clean up the bridge collapse in Baltimore. Fox's Ryan Schmelz reports.
Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg says it won't be quick, easy, or cheap to get the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore back up and running, but promises officials will, quote, get it done. The secretary was asked if there's any consideration to waive certain regulations to move the process along quicker.
Certainly we have a clear direction from the president to tear down any barriers, bureaucratic as well as financial, that could affect the timeline of this project.
At the White House, Ryan Schmelz, Fox News.
White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre says the U.S. is still asking for a ceasefire in Gaza.
We remain hopeful that we can broker a deal to secure the release of hostages and establish a temporary ceasefire. This is something that we've been asking for some time, a ceasefire, and this hostage deal obviously would allow us to bring home some hostages to their family, to their loved ones.
She hopes negotiations can lead to more humanitarian help being sent to Gaza. Your governor's making sure emergency response teams are ready for the April 8th solar eclipse. Donnie Burgess reports.
An executive order signed Wednesday by Governor Holcomb will allow Indiana to use emergency resources from other states. The goal is for Indiana to be as prepared as possible for any transportation or communication issues that could come up during the eclipse, as thousands of visitors are expected in the Hoosier state. This is all possible due to the partnerships provided by the Emergency Management Assistance Compact. Donnie Burgess, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
The final GOP gubernatorial debate's been scheduled for April 23rd. It'll be on IUPUI's campus. All six Republican candidates plan to be at the Hine Hall Auditorium that night. They'll answer questions starting at 7. It's a live audience, so you could be there if you'd like. And with traffic at 531, here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, on the north side, eastbound 465 before Allisonville Road. It's a crash on the right shoulder with stop-and-go traffic back to Westfield Boulevard. East side, northbound 465, stop-and-go 72 Penn Pike. Southbound lane slow from 70 down to Washington. Southbound 65 into downtown, stop-and-go traffic before MLK to Meridian Penn. Westbound 70 slows after rural through the north foot out to West Street MLK. Eastbound 70 stop. And go traffic from Tibbs Avenue to the south split. And on the south side, northbound 37 still loaded up Edgewood Avenue to 465 because of construction. Crash on the east side, Post Road at 30th. Traffic sponsored by Royal Spa. Everyone knows that soaking in Epsom salts can make you feel better. Now imagine soaking in Epsom salts in a Royal Spa hot tub. RoyalSpa.com. Ah, Royal Spa. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Clouds begin to decrease later on today, so some sunshine, but it still stays cool. Highs near 48. Clear skies tonight. Areas of frost developing with lows near 32. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the level on the go and on WIBC.com.
It's the Hammer and Nigel Show. Hello, I'm Nigel. Jason Hammer right over there with a special guest on the WIBC hotline.
He is an investigative reporter at the Daily Signal, and he also does the night program, the Tony Kinnett Cast, every evening right after our show at 7 o'clock. Tony Kinnett joins us. TK, how are you?
I am stellar, gentlemen. How are you?
Excellent. I'm good, man. So do you hate yourself like I do? Did you find yourself watching the full one-hour Indiana gubernatorial debate last night, Tonus?
No, and the funny thing is, my show was on at the same time, and to my delight, as the hour went on, more people started tuning in because it was a far better alternative than watching that snooze fest circus on TV.
You know, as much as I hate to give our esteemed colleague Rob Kendall any sort of credit, he was absolutely right. Those people on that stage, they're scared to death to go after Mike Braun. Let's be honest, Mike Braun is probably the front runner here, but I don't know if it's because those people on the stage want to get some sort of gig in his administration or what, but if I'm somebody that's is probably looking up at other people in the polling, I go out there guns blazing, and it was kind of a snooze fest yesterday.
You know what? I've kept this quiet long enough. There was a time about 6-7 months ago in which I was trying to provide a little bit of advice to the Doden campaign. I like Eric Doden. I think he's a really good guy. And I thought that he had some interesting ideas, regardless of the fact that a few of his policies needed work. And I advised him 6-7 months ago, you need to spend every single day attacking Braun. No one else matters. You need to show Indiana why you are better than Braun. That should be your only tactic. And the campaign ignored the advice. And as you can see, currently pulling it like 0.8% is not necessarily a great strategy. But hey, that's you know what happens when you decide to run your campaign against a front runner by ignoring the front runner, like DeSantis did for a long time in the presidential campaign, for instance. It doesn't work, and all you end up getting is pocket change and kind of looking like the sad lame duck in a mule competition.
You know, I heard Doden on Rob's show, the Kendall and Casey show, the other day. I really liked I liked him. I liked his ideas. I have no idea who voting for. I have no idea who I'm voting for in this governor's race yet, but I liked him. I don't have as big a problem with Braun as you or maybe Rob Kendall does. I mean, the gas tax thing, it is what it is. I'm wondering now, it just seems like these debates are a lot of platitudes and vagaries, as Rob put it earlier today. Is that a fair assessment?
I think so. I don't have a problem with Braun, actually. I'm currently torn between voting for Braun or for Hill. I think Rittenhour and Hill should have been on that stage, but I like Braun, honestly. He votes close to Mike Lee, which is one of my favorite senators.
Right.
I think the gas tax is something we can negotiate on, honestly. I know that that's like heresy, that like I actually believe that we can negotiate it down, but I think it's doable.
And if you watched that debate last night, and if you missed it, you can go on YouTube. It's only an hour long, and you can skip through it. Taxes, gas tax specifically, didn't get brought up until about 27 minutes into that debate, Tony. To me, like, I don't care what any other polling says. You know, they were talking about immigration in Indiana before they were talking about taxes yesterday. That should have been a much longer part of that debate.
Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. There are things that all Hoosier Republicans agree on. You don't like illegal immigration. Wow, you're breaking some new ground there, Copernicus. You want to lower taxes? Gee willikers, no kidding. Oh, man, you don't like California and New York? Whoa, that's crazy. How about we actually focus on the things that are contested among Hoosier Republicans? I want to know why Braun is different than Crouch, why Crouch is different than, who's that other guy, Chambers or something? That other guy no one knows. Who's different than, I want to know the differences between the candidates, because this is going to shock everyone. It's a primary. I know you're all Republicans. That's the name of the primary. So get into details, please.
Right. But my point being, though, and maybe I didn't explain this well, is that I think the average voter that's watching that, they don't know these people the way that we do. We live in this political bubble. This is how we get down. This is how we make a living. If you're the average person that turned on CBS 4 last night and you're seeing these people, maybe you've heard of Mike Braun because he's a senator, but that's about it. You didn't get to hear about why your paycheck is not being as stretched out as it used to be until about 30 minutes in. And in that same debate, they spent the same amount of time on time zone changes than they did on taxes.
Again, this is my criticism of the Indiana GOP. No one has to try, so no one tries. It's like our weird tradition that no one really knows why we've got it, but we do. You know, a lot like daylight savings time, for instance. And now we're sitting here watching this debate, and none of the candidates really shine. I'm not really seeing anything that makes me want to campaign for them. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just feel like, okay, you're all like the same shade of blue, kind of. I guess I'll just pick the one that I like the best, and that's just a real shame given this primary.
Do you think people that aren't like in this bubble like we are hear something from Suzanne Crouch when she says, hey, I'm going to get rid of the income tax? I mean, do ears perk up on that? I mean, I love Jamie Rittenhour saying she's, you know, going to try to get rid of the, did she say she's going to get rid of the property tax? Is that one of her things, Rittenhour, even though she wasn't on the stage?
I think she says smaller government, lower taxes. Yeah. I'm not sure which taxes. I haven't listened to all of her stuff with Rob.
She wants to get rid of the IEDC. I know that. But I'm just saying, when somebody says something like that, do ears perk up?
Well, the thing is, it has to reach the ears to perk up. And the fact of the matter is, when I actually look at their political advertisements and who they're trying to communicate to, the average Hoosier isn't getting that message because, again, Hoosiers don't care about the primary because there's not a reason to. So for Suzanne Crouch to come out there and go, axe the tax, it's like, it doesn't really sound like a plan. It just sounds like someone trying to simp for your vote.
Right, right. Like, as a sports betting host, I could say, I'm going to give everybody a free $1 million parlay. That doesn't mean that I'm actually going to do that, Tony. It's just, you know, it's fun for people to hear.
Remember, Andrew Yang ran on this in the Democrat primary. I'm going to give everyone $1,000 a month for life. Yes. He literally did the meme, and it did nothing for him. Because guess what? I don't believe that if Suzanne Crouch wins, she's going to axe the income tax. I don't believe her because she worked at Holcomb's administration for 8 years. And guess what? It didn't happen. So why would it suddenly happen now that she's sitting in the fancier chair? I just don't buy it.
One more thing locally here, and then we'll turn our attention to some national stuff. You were at that Donald Trump Jr. Jim Banks event yesterday. My son was there, too. But the thing that I love the most, and I heard this from you, and I heard this from my son, there were some liberal reporters there that were having their feelings hurt because their questions were being ignored.
So I also thought this was really funny. I met in person for the first time Adam Rennie's from Politico, national journalist, and we've spatted a couple of times on Twitter. But he and I went to the press gaggle, and we started asking questions, and both of our questions got answered because we didn't, you know, beat around the bush. But some of these guys behind the camera from local TV stations, whom I won't name, were getting actually pretty flustered and saying things like, well, I already asked that question. I mean, it was like some weird, jealous nerd in middle school upset that you answered a question right. And it's so hard to wonder why no one's watching 59 or 6 or 13. What a surprise that the whiny reporters showing up to events aren't getting their questions answered.
How was the event, by the way? What did you think?
It was pretty good. I think that Donald Trump should go sit in a building and not speak for 8 months and let Donald Trump Jr. do all of his campaigning. I'm not joking. It was phenomenal. He hit squatters' rights crap. He hit the woke garbage. He praised, like, American farmers. I was like, dude, give this man the mic. And Trump, honest to God, go play golf for 8 months. Like, seriously.
Tony Kennett from DailySignal.com. He's an investigative reporter and host of the Tony Kennett Cast weeknights here at 7 o'clock, 93 WIBC. Did you happen to read that article I sent you? Hammer and I did an all-new edition of Is It Racist yesterday. There's a school district located in the suburbs of Minneapolis. They are hiring an assistant superintendent to, quote, examine the presence of whiteness in the district. Can you maybe break this down a little bit for us? I mean, your background is in education and STEM and right. Administrator. And I'm wondering, like,
you're white, Tony. Are you the devil?
Yeah.
Well, see, that's the fun thing is that on my census tax forms, technically I'm not. I actually do get to claim the Native American tax credit and free dental and all that other junk.
Look at you, Elizabeth Warren. Congratulations.
Exactly. He's so legit, much. Though.
I'm very excited. I do have the fancy little card, unlike Pow Wow Chow over in Massachusetts. But I will point out that when I was at IPS, my colleagues informed me that I am white presenting, or I am phenotypically white, means you look white. And according to the left.
So that means Sammy Sosa's white now, too? Is that what that means?
I guess. I'm honestly impressed at all the ways we found to root out whiteness. And that's what these positions come down to. Now, it's amazing that in Minneapolis they would need a position to do this because all of the liberals in that district already do that every day anyway. I mean, good Lord, they got rid of the superintendent who was garbage at her job over at Hamilton Southeastern, and every progressive woman with short hair and Harry Potter glasses hasn't shut up about it for months. So, honestly, I don't know, man. I'm amazed that they're spending a superintendent-level salary on someone to examine whiteness. I'm just picturing that they're, like, walking through the building and, like, sniffing white students as they walk by.
How very Biden of them. What are you working on for the Daily Signal?
I just broke a huge piece on an Arizona school that was providing name change transgender clinic posters to elementary students. And I just found out a few minutes ago, the Arizona Department of Education is actually now investigating that school. So
I thought that kind of thing wasn't really going on. It was just kind of a narrative for the conservatives and
it's
a myth.
Right wing talking points,
yeah,
right?
Right.
Remember how bad Rakita got roasted because he introduced a panel a portal for parents to track this?
Sure, yeah.
The Indiana Department of Education, we don't know anything about this. Well, in Arizona, their Department of Education actually investigates these kind of things. So it's kind of nice to have.
And you got the big show coming up tonight?
That's right. Bill Whittle's interview finally breaks this evening. And then we've got some great culture stuff because Disney says that Star Wars needs colonizer conversations. So.
Oh, wonderful. Can't wait. Right after our show, 7 o'clock tonight, the Tony Kennett Cast. Tony Kennett, you're the best. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Nige, you're out on Friday.
Yes.
I'm out on Friday.
Yeah.
I've missed last week's Beer Sample Friday.
You don't want to miss two in a row, do you?
I'm not missing another one. We're going to do Beer Sample Wednesday.
Okay.
And I brought the beverages.
Oh, yeah. Let's do it. Next, the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Tony Katz here, and if you know me, you know I like my bourbon, and just like you, I like a good deal. So let me tell you about Hotel Tango Bourbon. Hotel Tango is a distillery right here in Indianapolis, started by Travis Barnes, a Marine who served three tours in Iraq. He wanted to craft spirits with the same discipline he learned in the Marine Corps. That's what Hotel Tango does. I've tried his bourbon. It's wonderful. It's a four-grain bourbon with a distinct mash bill. You get a little caramel and some of that aroma. You get a nice rye kick to balance it out. I'm not the only one who thinks it's good. Wine Enthusiast gave it a 94, and it won a gold at the San Francisco Spirits Competition. It's also under $40. Did I mention that? One of the 10 best bourbons under $40, according to Wine Enthusiast. Try it for yourself. Head down to wherever you buy fine spirits and try Hotel Tango for yourself. You'll be supporting local, supporting veterans, and getting yourself a great, sippable, enjoyable bourbon at a great price. Thanks to Hotel Tango for sponsoring the show. Hotel Tango, distilled with discipline. HotelTangoDistillery.com.
My husband Bob has Parkinson's and he needs more help now, and I need more support to help him. Thanks to Indiana Pathways for Aging, we're getting the support we need to help him right here at home, like with meal prep and basic personal care and even respite support for me.
Pathways provides Hoosier Medicaid members, age 60 and over, support for care their way, so they can live life their way. Eligible members can select a plan now. Call 87-PATHWAY-4 or visit in.gov/pathways.
All right, Hammer, I'm sick and tired of eating out of the same old places. That's why I go to Jay's Lobster and Fish Market. It's right there in the Garage Food Hall, Bottle Works District. I could eat the lobster mac and cheese every day, meals a day for a year.
It's so good. And you know what else is good there? Pavlova Cubano.
Oh, are you kidding me?
The best Cuban food in Indy. And the atmosphere is amazing. You walk through the Garage Food Hall, it's like you're going through Vegas. So whether you're getting a little lobster mac and cheese or a Cuban sandwich, tell them Hammer and Nigel sent you.
Your home is your sanctuary. Get the peace of mind you deserve with a free estimate on a Generac automatic standby generator for your home from Generator Supercenter, the nation's number one Generac generator dealer. With expert installation and 24-hour monitoring, Generator Supercenter won't leave you in the dark. Financing is available. Take control of your power today with Generator Supercenter. Call 317-827-0808. Generator Supercenter of Indianapolis, 317-827-0808.
You can trust your flush to us. Howald Plumbers are the best in the business. Water heaters, leaky faucets or toilets, sump pumps, drain lines. Howald Plumbers keep water flowing. Howald Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing, where coming home never felt so good. At Howald Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing, we do plumbing. Water heaters, leaky faucets or toilets, sump pumps, drain lines. Howald Plumbers keep water flowing. Howald Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing, where coming home never felt so good.
Why is the $29 tune-up special from Broad Ripple Service Experts such a big deal? You save $100 and they could save your AC. Broad Ripple Service Experts can help restore your AC's reliability and extend its life, saving you up to 30% on energy bills and keeping your equipment warranty valid. And their service is 100% guaranteed. Broad Ripple Service Experts is all about making you feel right at home. Get total home comfort with their $29 tune-up. Call 866-EXPERTS today. License numbers HL11000009 and PC1990002.
Join Free G Auctioneers for the Spring Midwest Construction and Farm Public Auction on Thursday, April 4th in Clayton. Bid live on-site or online at buyfreeg.com. License AC312-00002.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Matt Baer has a look at the roads.
All right, Hammer, this just happened. Looking at the northeast side, northbound 465 at East 71st Street. Looks like a single vehicle crash with a pickup truck facing the wrong way in the interstate. It's blocking the Gore Point, partially blocking the right lane with traffic stopped now to East 56th Street. This is not in the express lane. It's not in the exit lanes to I-69. It's right there on the main part of 465. Again, right lane block stopping traffic. Crash reported northbound 65 in the north. A split. We have a little bit of a slowdown from the north split out to 21st Street. Eastbound 70 stop and go from West Street into the south. A split. Traffic sponsored by Indy Decorative Concrete, Indy's leader in patio installation, now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
45 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center at 93 WIBC.
Right now,
Hammer and Nigel present
beer sample.
Wednesday.
I got some beers. Let's drink them, huh?
Beers on sale, people. Come down, get you some.
Brought to you by Thompson Furniture and Mattress in Columbus with free delivery. Hammer and I are both gone Friday. You're not missing a beer sample Friday two times in a row because you were gone last Friday.
Right, that ain't happening. So the selection I brought today, I think we may have tried it on the show before, but I thought it was topical.
Okay.
So yesterday we had a conversation about movie memorabilia that you would like to have. And
yes,
your choice was the sweater from the dude in The Big Lebowski.
That would be amazing. His sweater, his sunglasses, and maybe even the jellies, sandals that he wears.
Not the rug.
You mean the rug miterated upon by Wu?
So with that being said, I saw this and I thought, you know what? We were just talking about this. Here you go, Nige.
Oh, yeah. Right. Bad Dad Brewing. The dude abides. I love it. This is, it's a pilsner from Bad Dad Brewing.
And such an awesome looking can. I'll take a picture of this and I'll put it up on our social media
here. It's got like a sketch of the dude on it almost.
Listen, it's not Friday.
I know.
But it's my Friday. Cheers, everybody.
Oh, man, that is so good.
You're going to need about five or six more of these bad boys to get through that night number two of debate tonight.
Oh, boy, I can't wait. Yeah, we'll have all the action tomorrow. I'll watch it so you won't have to. Ladies and gentlemen, a Wednesday edition of Beer Sample Friday. More coming up next, right?
Top stories. We'll talk about last night's debate next.
This is the most exciting time of the year, and we want you to go all the way, even if your team doesn't. March on, Indiana, in a Hubler quality pre-owned vehicle. Shop any of Hubler's 12 locations and choose from over 1,000 vehicles. Chevys, Fords, GMCs, Buicks, Nissans, Acuras, Mazdas, Hondas, and many more. All makes, all models, certified vehicles, luxury vehicles, even the hard-to-find ones. Every Hubler Q-certified vehicle is covered by a 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty, plus a 128-point vehicle inspection and a free Carfax history report. Hubler's got you covered for 100,000 miles. Busted brackets not included. So what drives Indiana? DriveHubler.com. For over 1,000 vehicles, visit any of our 12 locations.
Hubler's got you covered.
Warranty on select models less than 9 years old.
I had changed the locks. Didn't even know where she was living. And then one night she calls to say she's getting treatment. Can I drive? I almost hung up. But then I thought, that's my kid. I chose to put away the hurt and the fear and just see my girl.
Addiction is a disease. Standing by a loved one as they fight it will test your faith, patience, and sanity. But it's possible when you see the person, not just their disease. Learn more at cbeyondtheaddiction.org.
Why choose a Sleep Number smart bed?
Can it keep me warm when I'm cold?
Wait, no, I'm always hot.
Sleep Number does that. The Climate 360 smart bed actively cools or warms up to 13 degrees on either side for your ideal